Hearing of the Subcommittee on Senate Bill Number 2374 or an act prohibiting the online placing of bets for all Lotto games and all instant paper games. We have the following resource persons. From the Bureau of Internal Revenue, we have Attorney Ralbert John Neil Tibayan. From the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, we have Chairman Junie E. Kua, General Manager Melquiades A. Robles, the Chairperson of the Bids and Awards Committee, Attorney Lauro Patiag, and the Vice Chairperson of the Bids and Awards Committee, Attorney John Derek Porciancula. From the Philippine Online Lottery Agents Association Incorporated, we have Ms. Evelyn Marquin Javier. From Pacific Online Systems Corporation, we have Mr. Christopher C. Villaflor. And from the Office of the Government Corporate Counsel, we have Attorney Francis Julius Romeo P. Del Valle. That will be all, Your Honor.
Thank you, Comsec. My esteemed colleagues and to all here present today, magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Today's hearing centers on the discussion of SB number 2374, filed by this representation last April 23, 2023. This piece of legislation is aimed to safeguard public welfare, protect vulnerable individuals, and encourage responsible gambling practices, thereby contributing to a safer and more regulated landscape in the nation. Halos kasabay ng nasabing panukalang batas, ang Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office ay lumagda sa isang Memorandum of Agreement noong August 30, 2023 para sa one-year test run period for web-based application betting platform. Isa pamamaraan upang mapatupad ng PCSO ang e-Lotto or the launching of the new PCSO online games that would change the existing Lotto betting system. Ito ay nagdudulot ng matinding pangamba sa mga Lotto agents na may existing contracts sa PCSO. Hindi lingit sa ating kalaman na mga Lotto agents ay matagal ng kaagapay ng PCSO sa pagpapatupad ng mandato nito sa ilalim ng RA 1169 o ng PCSO Charter, mayigit kumulang na tatlong dekada. Ilan lang sa mga reklamo na natanggap namin ay ang malalaking pagbabago ng tratado ng PCSO sa mga Lotto agents, kagaya ng paghigpit ng mga patakaran na nagresulta sa agarang pagkansela ng kanilang agency agreement. Kasama na lang dito ang number 1, pag-deactivate ng Lotto Terminal Ticket Cancellation Feature na nagresulta sa malaking abono sa mga Lotto agents. Number 2, simula ng transition sa FLX machine, shutdown at hindi na nag-ooperate ang mga old machine at ito ay kinukumpiska na ng PCSO. Number 3, pagtanggal ng kanilang hospitalization benefits at marami pang iba. Nagkakaisa lahat ng Lotto agents na mga panggigipit na isinasagawa ng PCSO ay tungo sa pangkalahatan termination ng agency agreements ng mga Lotto agents kapalit ng 100% transition sa operation ng e-Lotto. In its efforts to address the issues raised by PCSO stakeholders, this committee continuously endeavored to invite PCSO to shed light in all the controversies arising out of its move to transition to e-Lotto. Our call fell on deaf ears. PCSO sent all kinds of excuses purposely to avoid and prevent this committee from performing its constitutionally mandated task. This has to end right here, right now. PCSO has to defend its stand, not to run and hide. When you are asked by the Senate to attend hearings, you have to make time to attend the hearings. Ano bang gusto niyong patunayan sa mga umiyang Pilipino at patuloy kayong umiiwas sa mga imbitasyon namin dito sa Senado? May tinatago ba kayo tungkol sa mga nais naming pag-usapan at mabigyan ng kasagutan sa hearing na ito? Face the issues that must be faced. This body will not stop until we get all the answers we need to the fullest satisfactions of everybody. Magandang hapon po. Now, may we ask the agencies invited and resource persons to proceed with the presentation, and for the orderly conduct of our proceedings, may we request, well, actually, since ako lang nandito ngayon, and gusto ko mapaiksi na po itong usapan natin, at mag-direct to the point na tayo, umpisa na po siguro natin sa mga pagtatanong. Meron po akong kopya rito ng contract between the PCSO and the e-lotto provider. Okay. Now, para sa mga taga Lotto.
Anong po, ang pangalan ng provider? Pakisulat mo ha. Sulat niya, siyempre.
Right. My first question. Meron pong opinion ang OGCC, Office of the Government Corporate Council, dated April 19, 2023, because humiling po si General Manager Mr. Robles ng opinion from OGCC tungkol po doon sa pagkakaroon ng e-lotto. At sinabi po ng OGCC na number one, hindi pwede illegal at kailangan humingi muna ng permiso from the OP, Office of the President. Ang tanong, humingi kayo ng permiso o ng opinion sa OGCC at sinabi ng OGCC, no can do, bakit ipinagpatuloy pa rin yung pagkikipagtransa? Dito sa Pacific, ano? Bakit pinagpatuloy pa rin pagkikipagtransaksyon sa Pacific Online Systems Corporation? Anybody would like to answer, PCSO? But first of all, OGCC nandito pala. Sige, para ma-make sure natin na tama itong nababasa naming kontrata or memorandum of agreement. OGCC, your attorney Francis Julius Romeo de Valle?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, I have here in front of me ito memorandum of agreement and then an opinion from OGCC stating na kailangan magkaroon muna ng permission from the OP bago mag-proceed sa online ng e-lotto.
Yes, Your Honor. I was informed earlier that the OGCC has issued that opinion, opinion number 70. However, I'm not the one in charge and I'm not involved in the drafting of that opinion. So I cannot speak with regard to that opinion, Your Honor.
Okay, sige, hindi ikaw nag-draft ng opinion, pero yung opinion na binigay ng OGCC ay legit. Ibig sabihin, legitimate yun na kailangan ang isang government-owned corporation, pag sila ay magkaroon ng anumang klaseng project and enter into an agreement with any entity, they should have permission from the Office of the President since they are under the Office of the President. You agree?
Your Honor, I have not gone through that opinion, Your Honor.
Ba't ka papunta rito kung wala ka palang alam? So useless ka lang sa amin. Then dapat policy na kita rito. Puro you don't know, I don't know. Nabasa niyo na po ba ito? Alam niyo naman siguro ang reason ko ba't kayo pinapunta rito, di ba? O bakit puro ka, I don't know?
Your Honor, the OGCC was only informed of the hearing yesterday. And I was only apprised that I'm the one assigned today to attend the hearing.
Who assigned you to attend the hearing today?
Our the office, Your Honor, the GCC, Your Honor.
Pero nabasa mo na itong kontra. Ito, itong Memorandum of Agreement, itong MOA.
No, Your Honor.
You were not informed by the committee? About the purpose of you being called here?
I was informed that the purpose is with regard to the proposed Senate bill, Your Honor.
Okay.
So that's the one that I studied, Your Honor.
Kaya na, dun sa Senate bill, kinukonta namin yung pagkakaroon ng Iloto. So dapat napag-aralan mo na yun. Being a lawyer, you should know better. Sana na-review mo na itong contract.
Yes, Your Honor, but as the representative of our office, I can only speak based on the official perspective of the office on the contract.
Okay. Kasi something's fishy here for me, Attorney De Valle. Okay, I don't know you. Pero unang-una, nag-invite kami doon sa mga tao na may kinalaman dito sa gumawa ng MOA, at yung taong nakapirma dito sa MOA hindi pumunta at ikaw pinadala, at yung pinadala dito walang alam. So ano pa yung sense na ako'y magtatanong sa iyo tungkol sa contract na ito kung puro ka walang alam? You follow me, sir? So meron ba ako mapapakinabangan sa iyo sa araw na ito? If you say wala, then I'll let you go. Meron ba? You're an attorney, you're a lawyer. How long have you been with the OGCC?
For more than one year, 1 month, Your Honor.
1 year, 1 month. Okay, so meron akong mapapakinabang sa'yo. Unless kung sabihin mo, 1 day ka pa lang. So meron ka masasagot sa akin one way or the other. Right, and I don't want to hear na puro I don't know. Tama, sir? Well, we're at this MOA. Can we give this gentleman a copy of the MOA para pwede niyang habang pinag-usapan yung mga ibang topic, pwede niyang ma-review, and then you might want to call these people here na pumirma. I'll give you time to call them. Is that okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yung hindi pumunta, yung nagpadala sa'yo dito, call them. And since you're the corporate lawyer, then call everybody you can call about this MOA. Okay? Kasi ayoko na, ito kasing pinaka-reason kung bakit nandito ka. And then, hindi mo masagot para lumilitaw, useless ka. Sorry, sir. Okay. Now, sino sasagot sa PCSO? Mr. Junicoa, Mr. Robles. Meron na pong humingi kayo ng opinion, kayo po mismo humingi ng opinion sa OGCC tungkol sa pagkakaroon ng Iloto, at sabi ng OGCC, opinion nila na hindi dapat unless kung talaga magpupumilit kayo, you need a permission from the OP, Office of the President.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chair. I would like to beg your indulgence. If in the past I wasn't able to come here, we were busy and I sent a representative, Your Honor, who is very capable of answering your questions. Now, dun po sa review that you were referring to, I don't think it is about the test run of the web-based application. That was for another e-game and birthday panalo po. And that is not in reference to what we have with the e-loto namin. So we have here po the contract review 2404 series of 2023 from the OGCC, and we have the summary here. We may furnish you, or I can read it po. Kung gusto po ninyo, iba po yung topic na yan. It was in a different topic.
Okay, go ahead, read.
The OGCC view on the web application. The OGCC recognizes the need to contract with private entities for their technical expertise and the lack of necessary technology and legal framework to effectively implement online gambling schemes and methods. The OGCC's opinion may be summarized into three categories relating to the compliance by PCSO to its previous opinions and areas for improvement and or compliance. Okay. PCSO's compliance. The procurement of the web-based application is within PCSO's mandate. This is according to GOCC. The PCSO complied with the promulgation of the rules and regulations of the WABP, as well as the requirement of publication and posting prior to the effectivity and implementation of the WABP rules. PCSO conducted stringent selection and evaluation process in selecting POSC as the proponent agent. The WABP provided safeguards and security protocols to ensure protection. The areas for improvement, Your Honor, is the board resolution authorizing Pacific Online, the company's president, to enter and sign agreement should be attached to the MOA.
So with that letter, you are being authorized by OGCC to go ahead?
If I may, they have requirements, Mr. Chairman, and ito po yung summary.
Hindi nga, Mr. Robles. So, yung binabasa nyo ngayon sa amin dito, inauthorize kayo ng OGCC to go ahead with Pacific Online System Corporation para dun sa Iloto project?
To make it clear, Mr. Chair, this is just a test. Test po ang hinihingi namin ng permiso. Kasi wala naman po kami problema to
kaya
ask
po,
the permission
ng,
of the President.
Kaya po, test, pinapayagan kayo.
Meron po mga requirements sa amin and we complied with it.
So, can we see a copy of that letter? And when was it given to you?
If I may, Mr. Chair, I have it with me. Would you like me to
kasi
read
dito,
it?
Dito kasi, Mr. Robles, dito sa opinion na ibinigay ng OGCC, opinion number 070, series of 2023, okay? Makapal to, maraming pages to, pero I'll go straight to the page wherein it says here, aside from OGCC's conduct of an individual review of any contract, agreement, or arrangement of PCSO with a game proponent for the launching of an online game on an experimental test run basis, PCSO shall likewise secure the Office of the President's approval pursuant to Section 10 of the PCSO Charter.
Mr. Chairman, if I may, that is referring to a different game. Birthday panalo po yan.
We're talking about online dito. Walang sinabi dito birthday panalo. It says here, launching of new games with a game proponent as an agent on an experimental test line basis and procurement of several online betting systems or platforms. Never na minention dito ang sinasabi ninyong bingo panalo.
Birthday panalo po. Ito birthday po yung aming sa web-based application betting platform, which is specific with Pacific Online Systems, dated 21 December 2023.
Yung sinasabi niyang 70, it's on page 17, birthday panalo.
It doesn't matter, Mr. Robles, regardless, sinasabi ng OGCC, any contract agreement, any contract, regardless kung yan ay birthday panalo o e-loto, dito, very clear, any agreement or any contract or agreement or arrangement of PCSO with a game proponent for the launching of an online game. So yung birthday panalo, online yon, yung e-loto, online yon. So sinasabi, any online game, kailangan may permiso from the OP. Regardless, kahit na ibang game yung sinasabi mo. The fact na sinasabi ng OGCC, ulitin ko for the end time, any contract agreement or arrangement of PCSO with a game proponent for the launching of an online game. Online yung iloto, di ba? Yung birthday panalo, online pareho. Pagbabanggay mo, parehong online. So therefore, kung pareho silang online, pareho dapat may permiso sa Office of the President.
I respect your opinion, Mr. Chairman. But I'm specifically referring to the memorandum of the OGCC na contract review nila sa amin of 21 December 2023, which is much later, Mr. Chairman.
Regardless, I see what you're coming from. I understand what you're saying. Exactly. Pero again, nais kong ipa-remind sa inyo lahat dito, sa iyo especially, Mr. Robles, yung sinabi rito ng OGCC. Sabi mo, ibang laro yung hiningan nyo ng opinion. Ang hiningan nyo ng opinion ay tungkol doon sa birthday panalo. Okay, nandun na tayo. Online game. Tama. PCSO na Iloto, online game din. Parehong online game. Regardless kung magkaiba sila ng hiningan nyo ng opinion. Pero the fact na it states here na online game should have the permission of the Office of the President, that you should have secured permission from the OP. I'd like to ask the opinion of Mr. Juni Cua here, the chairman of the PCSO. Mr. Cua, ano po masasabi nyo?
Well, tama naman po yung binasa ninyo kanina na kinakailangan na humingi ng permiso sa Office of the President.
I'm sorry po, sir. So, you agree with me doon po sa nabasa ko, Mr. Cua being the chairperson of PCSO?
Well, nakita ko naman pong binasa niyo yun doon sa provision ng charter. At yun din po ang pagkakaalam ko.
Thank you, Mr. Cua. Okay, Mr. Robles, ayan, pati yung chairman ninyo sa PCSO, naiintindihan po yung sinasabi ko, naiintindihan po yung binasa ko. Very simple lang po talaga yon. Actually, pang kindergarten lang po yon na sinasabi rito, pag online, kailangan may permiso mula sa OP, online po yung Iloto. Sana po, kumuha kayo ng permiso sa Office of the President, binypass nyo po yung OP sa proyektong ito. Number one violation po yun. Why was it violated?
Mr. Chairman, assuming that that is correct, we are just on a test run po. We have to test this before having it approved. Kasi po, it would look, kung hindi naman po gumagana, pag naunaw naman po yung approval, eh medyo mahirap din naman po yan. So we have to be very clear, this is on a test run.
Exactly, precisely, definitely, absolutely, you're right. Pero bago ka mag-test run, you should secure permission from the OP before any move whatsoever.
Mr. Chair, again, you were referring to a different game. Yan po ang pinanggagalingan
ko. Sir, nakakala ko tapos na tayo sa different game, regardless kung anumang game yun. Basta we're talking about online, right? Pag online, kailangan may permiso from the OP. Period.
Okay? Mr. Chair, if you, I may, I would like to read from you a memorandum from the Executive Secretary. If I may, Your Honor.
Yes, sir.
Upon evaluation, the PCSO is advised that it has sufficient authority, is in a better position to evaluate and approve its technical guidelines on betting platforms, considering that this deals with the minimum technical specifications required for betting platforms of PCSO game, like hardware systems, architecture requirements, interface requirements, and software specifications. Finding that these are matters that will be better evaluated by PCSO as the implementing agency for its lottery games, this office defers to the PCSO's expertise on the approval of the same. Ito po rin po regarding the betting platform po, which Iloto is a betting platform, Your Honor.
So, ang ibig nyo sabihin, with that letter that you just read, and what date is that? So, pinapayagan kayo ng Executive Secretary na to go ahead at kukontrahin itong opinion ng OGCC. Kasi very clear to me, merong opinion ng OGCC, ngayon naglalabas ng opinion, ang Executive Secretary na sabi na upon your discretion, para i-simplify ko na lang, na pwede kayong mag-decide na mag-enter into a project such as online gaming na kumukontra sa opinion ng OGCC. So, ibig sabihin, yung Executive Secretary pumaparing na sa inyo
at pinapayagan na kayo na i-bypass itong nakalagay dito sa opinion ng OGCC.
I think, Mr. Chairman, we are referring to two different opinions. So, as far as we're concerned, hindi po namin na we're not going against the opinion of the OGCC.
No, sir. The opinion of OGCC is very simple. Pinapalawak lang po natin. We're talking of online here, sir. Online lang po. Huwag na natin ibahin pa. Online lang. It's the same animal. Yung birthday panalo and iloto, online din yung, sir. Wala tayong pinagkaiba dito. Kasi ang sinasabi niyo po, may binabasa kayong sulat na wala po akong kopya niyan, na parang sinasabi ng Executive Secretary, if I read it right, kung tama yung pagkabasa ko, na pinapayagan kayo, it's your discretion na gumawa ng anumang klaseng project na pwedeng kasama na dyan yung online betting. Kayo nang bahala gumawa ng mga paraan sa technicalities and all. Pinapayagan na kayo ng Executive Secretary. And I don't know kung nabasa ba ng Executive Secretary itong opinion ng OGCC. Sana pinadalhan nyo si Executive Secretary ng opinion. Sir, nagbibigay ka ng opinion yan pero may opinion ng OGCC. Pinagbanggan nyo sana. But, siguro baka hindi siguro nabasa ito ng Executive Secretary, kasi kung nabasa ito ni ES, then he might not have issued that kind of letter. Kasi kung ako sa Executive Secretary at pinabasa mo sa akin to, ba't pa ako mag-issue ng sulat ng ganun? Sasabihin ko, heck, hindi ko ba magayon yung OGCC? Kasi sigurado ako si ES, he'll make sure na talagang nagko-confront tayo sa lahat ng mga patakaran, sa lahat ng mga protocol sa departamento na executive.
If I may, Mr. Chair?
Yes, sir.
Yung birthday panalo po is a game. Yung pong e-lotto is a betting platform. Malaki pong pagkakaiba yun, Mr. Chairman. So, hindi ho pwedeng referring to the same po yun eh.
Ito po, sir, ano? Philippine Charity, meron po ba kayong kopya nito? Opinion number 070, series of 2023. I would presume you have a copy of this. April 19, 2023. Ito po. For attention, Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, Melquiades A. Robles, kayo po ito, General Manager, regarding, ito na po, launching of new games with a game proponent as an agent of an experimental test run basis. Ito na nga po yun, test run basis. Sinabi niyo na po kanina yun. Experimental test run basis and procurement of several online betting systems or platforms. So, dalawa na yon. Sapul na dito yung iloto at sapul na rin yung birthday panalo. Ayan na, sir. May copy ho ba kayo na ito, Mr. General Manager? Okay. Dito pa po sa page 5. In accordance with the contract on PCSO service providers, Philippine Gaming Management Corporation and Pacific Online Systems Corporation binanggit. Di ba? Binanggit dito yung Pacific Online was online. Itong Pacific Online, ito po yung test run ninyo sa Iloto. Doon po sa birthday panalo, Pacific din ho ba ang provider?
Hindi po, Your Honor. And it's just a proposal po.
Exactly. So, doon sa birthday panalo, sinasabi mo kanina, ininsist nyo magkaiba. Hindi pala Pacific yon. E Pacific ang binimension dito.
Ano po yan, yung dati pong provider po yan. You have to understand po na dati po dalawang provider po ang PCSO.
Sino bang ang current provider?
Mr. Chairman, if I may, we have the lotto, the lottery, ano po, yung the over-the-counter lottery. Ito po, meron pong dating PGMC tsaka POSC. So, in that context po, para maintindihan natin, ngayon po pinag-isa na yan under one joint venture. So, para po ma-mention nila yan, it was a long time ago po yan. Kaya nga po sinasabi ko, we are guided by the more recent one. Ito nga pong memorandum na sinasite ko on the web application-based program. So, yung PLS na po ngayon yan sa lottery namin, Philippine Lottery System. Kaya hindi na nga po kasama yung PGMC and the POSC on the traditional, on the usual over-the-counter. Kaya po, we really have to be specific kung ano ang hiningi namin ng opinion. Kasi magkakasala sa labat po yan. Iba po ang context, yung backdrop po ng sinasabi nyo na yung sa birthday panalong hinihingi namin.
Precisely. I see what you're saying. I know where you're coming from. But you should understand, ito pong sulat ng OGCC na pinadala sa inyo, I hope you have a copy of this. Very clear po. Plain and simple. Ulitin ko po, paulit-ulit na tayo rito para mas maintindihan natin. Regarding launching of new games with a game proponent of an agent on an experimental test run basis. Yan na yung iloto.
Your Honor, if I may, iloto po is not a new game. Existing na po ang loto natin.
Yan
po
yung, we're talking about the experimental electronic loto.
It's a betting platform, Your Honor.
Betting platform, we're talking about e-loto, electronic betting. It's a betting platform but still covered yun ng opinion ng OGCC. You know, Mr. Robles, the reason ng gagalit ako rito because nakatanggap ako ng maraming kumpenta. The last time you weren't here kasi, I talked to several loto agents, yung betting stations. Marami sa kanila mga OFWs, mga retirees. Nag-invest sila, bumuo sila ng pera doon. And now, mawalan silang trabaho. Mawalan sila ng kita. You didn't even consult them. Miss Evelyn Marking Javier, if I'm not mistaken, presidente ho kayo ng mga lotto agents.
Yes.
Were you consulted?
Yes, Chair. Nasalado na po yung 2,000 na outlets po.
Ano po?
Nasarado na po.
Ano yung sabi po nasarado?
There are 2,000 lotto outlets na nasarado na po dahil nabigyan na po ng termination noong October
2,000.
I mean, nag-start po yung 300 tas yung remaining pong 1,600 plus.
So ilan po lahat ang nasarado?
2,000 po asa.
2,000. Ano pong binigay na reason bakit po sinara po yung 2,000 na lotto outlets?
Wala pong machine daw.
Wala nang machine. Yun lang pong binigay na reason. Pero were you consulted na na-inpurbahan po kayo na magkakaroon kami ng e-loto?
Hindi po.
Na posible maapektuhan ang ilan sa inyo o marami sa inyo?
To my understanding, Chair, with the previous administration, they had plans of having that. Parang pag-aaralan pa po. We were just surprised na ang bilis-bilis lang po siyang na-apply.
So yung previous administration, before Mr. Robles became the general manager, so meron na kayong narinig na plano?
May plano po.
But you, na, pero nakonsulta kayo?
Opo, alam po namin.
Alam nyo. Ang kinagulat nyo na lang, all of a sudden, boom, natuloy na.
Opo.
Okay. Mr. Robles, you might want to answer.
Thank you very much na in-acknowledge yun na it's not under my time. Kung nga po ang tatanungin nyo po, it should be 11,000 outlets. Had it been under my watch, Mr. Chairman, hindi ako papayag sa 6,500. No? That is a fact. Hindi po under my watch to. And I even asked my managers, why did you allow? And sila po ay kausap ng GM. I'm surprised why they did not raise that up. They're very close po with the past administration. So, well, it's they have their reasons for not saying it. Tama po sila. Hindi po dapat. But ang trust naman of that administration is to modernize the 25-year-old system. Now, dalawa pa nga na laging nagbe-breakdown. So, tama po kayo. Hindi po dapat pinasarayan at marami pong nawalan. At even po kami sana, we could be getting more income had the previous administrator not implemented that. When I came, awarded na po yan. May timetable na po ang implementation.
Ms. Javier?
To my understanding, because I was there during the opening, What is the PCSO then said that they're going to initially order 6,500 because katatapos lang po ng pandemic, hindi po yata kakayanin na ganun kadami yung order nila ng machine. So we were just wondering, I mean, with due respect po, no, GM, nung time po na nag-order po ng machine na 6,500, kayo na po yung nakaupo.
Your Honor, that is a big lie. That is a big lie. Our records will bear us out. I will have to correct this because this is a very, very big lie. And if she's under oath, Your Honor, she will be in trouble.
To my understanding po, I mean, okay, granting po na ano na sila yung nag-order niyan. Pero during your time, alam niyo po na maa-apektuhan yung 2,000 na agent. Sana po, gumawa na lang din po kayo ng paraan na tulungan po kami na wag pong masarado yung 2,000 na yan. Kaya po, masama po yung loob ng mga Lotto agents kasi parang dahil po dyan sa iLotto, parang hindi yun na po tinulungan yung mga iba na makapagbukas po sila. Kasi dati ho, pre-termination lang, sumulat kayo, tapos ginawang termination, tapos nag-stoppage. From the stoppage itself po, dapat hindi na po kayo nag-issue mismo ng termination na kayo po yung nakapirma. Doon po yung talagang alam na nila na talagang wala na pong aasahan. Kung stoppage po yan, kung mag-aantay po ng machine, sana hindi na lang po sila terminate.
So ano nangyari po doon na misavir doon sa 2000 na
napasara? Sarado na po sila lahat. Sarado na po lahat yung ano. Yun nga po yung humihingi sila ng tulong sa akin na kung maaari po na mabigyan sila ng chance na makapagbukas ulit. Ang problema po, wala po talagang available na machine. Pero open naman po nang mag-apply ulit. Pero problema po, mag-aantay nga po sila kung merong kung kailan po magmamachine. Pero to my understanding, hindi pa po yata nag-uumpisa yung procurement or do sinasabi po ng mga branch managers na magkakaroon po. Saka before po, umasa po yung mga ibang mga agents po na hanggat wala pa pong machine, yung po ng mga lumang machine namin na ginamit dito sa Luzon, ang ipapagamit. Ang alam ko po, parang dati pumayag nga po na yun ang gamitin. Hindi po namin alam kung anong nangyari, kung bakit. Kasi kung I already approach also po, no, the OGCC, no, that's why I was late last time in coming here. Nakiusap po ako doon kay Attorney Quevedo na kung pwede pong i-extend po yung ELA para po hindi na muna po sila magsarado at pagbibigyan sila hanggat 4 months. Ang pakiusap lang niya po sa akin na i-inform ko daw po si GM na mag-apila lang para magkaroon po ng time na wag sila munang masarado kasi naaawa.
So you're not granted your request for an appeal?
Kasi po, hinihingi lang po ni Attorney Quevedo that time is kung pwede daw pong sumulat sa kanila ng letter po si GM or si Chairman Kuwa na humihingi po sila ng extension para ho magkaroon po ng time kung merong o-order na machine or something. Pero sinabi ko po yun kay AGM Arnel Casas na yun po yung request ni Attorney Quevedo na kung pwede gumawa po sila ng sulat na nire-request po nila na ma-extend po yung ano yung ELA para patuloy pa po sila na makapatuloy po na makapagpatay at hindi masarado yung 2,000 kasi naaawa rin po siya dun sa mga agents na yun. At that particular time, parang nag-follow up ako, parang sabi po, hindi naman po talaga nangyari na nakagawa po ng apela.
Kasi Mr. Robles, 2,000 na mga Lotto agents, sinibak nyo, tinanggalan nyo sila ng hanap buhay, pinatay nyo in short. Pero yung kita sana napupunta sa kanila, napunta ngayon sa Pacific Online Systems Corporation. Meron kayong pinatay na pagkarami-rami, 1,000 ang pinatay ninyo at isa lang ang inyong binuhay kapalit ng 2,000. Ito na nga yung online.
Mr. Chair, that is baseless, I would tell you. I'm sorry, but I think the figures will show that...
Who are you to say it's baseless?
Mr. Chairman...
Wait a minute! 2,000 na talagang given na... Yung numbers na sinasabi niya, exact numbers yan, 2,000 ang natanggalan ng hanap buhay. Am I right, Ms. Javier?
Yes, Chair, you're correct.
So, meron kayong 2,000 na pinatay nyo.
It is not,
let me finish and then let you talk. 2,000 ang tinanggalan nyo ng hanap buhay, pinatay nyo yung negosyo, and then kapalit ng 2,000, isang kumpanya lang ang inyong binuhay. Go ahead, Mr. Robles.
Hindi po ako may gawa niyan, Mr. Chairman. Dumating po ako awarded, Mr. Chairman, if I may. If I may, Mr. Chairman, it is not under my watch that the PLS was awarded. 5.8 billion po yan. It is a modernization of the lottery system, Mr. Chairman. I came, it was already on the implementation stage.
But you were the
stage,
one who asked for an opinion from OGCC, and OGCC gave you an opinion saying na hindi.
Hey, are we, where are we, Mr. Chairman? Are we on the pulai?
Yes, later na yung pulai. Mr. Robles, dalawa dito ang issue eh. Una, nung nagkaroon itong Pacific Online Systems Corporation, pinatay ang 2,000 mga lotto agents. Pangalawa, nung humingi kayo ng opinion sa OGCC at sinabihan kayo ng OGCC ng opinion na kailangan humingi kayo ng permiso sa Office of the President, and yet you did not. Attorney Francis De Valle, kanina pa kayo nagbabasa nung binigyan namin kayo ng kopya. What's your opinion on that letter? That MOA? It's your time to shine. Come on.
Your Honor, we all, the OGCC already issued an opinion that is currently being the subject of this discussion. The opinion speaks for itself, Your Honor. I might be misquoted if I make an interpretation. So,
no, you're an attorney. You're a lawyer. You should know better. Pwede ka magsalita.
Yes, exactly.
On behalf of the OGCC and in reference to this letter or opinion issued by the office where you present.
Exactly, Your Honor, with all due respect, my training would tell me that the document speaks for itself.
Okay. When you say the document speaks for itself, meaning?
The opinion, Your Honor, that was issued by the Office of the Government Corporate Counsel, Your Honor.
So that means yung sinasabi rito na sana humingi ng opinion sa Office of the President cover dito itong online gaming system ng Pacific Online Systems Corporation. Tama?
Your Honor,
don't look at him.
Yeah, yes, Your Honor. Basically, the...
No, yes or no lamang, attorney. So, sabi mo, it is what it is. Parang ganon, di ba? Now, yung nakasulat dito na opinion, di ba? Now, yung nakasulat dito na opinion ng OGCC, does this cover the online Lotto o Iloto? Yes or no lang? Huwag na tayo magpasikot-sikot dito, sir. Nabasa mo naman ah. At tinawag mo, I would assume you would have called people na who could give you enlightenment on this issue. Yun ang gusto kong tanongin. Kasi sinasabi ni Mr. Robles, magkaiba. Magkaibang laro. At itong dokumento kasi ito, galing sa OGCC. So kaya binigyan kita ng kopya para basahin mo. At pagkatapos, come up with your own opinion, being the lawyer of OGCC, and at the same time, make some phone calls. Do it right now. Open pa naman siguro opisina, 2 o'clock pa lamang. Call.
Your Honor, the signatories of that opinion is currently in a meeting with the Department of Justice.
Okay, sige. Wala yung mga signatories. But make some phone calls, and kung kinakailang basahin mo yung mga libro ninyo dyan sa OGCC, mag-utos ka na basahin kung ito ba ay tumutugma. Yung mga, ito bang nakasulat dito tumutugma doon sa mga libro ninyo, kung anong sinasabi sa mga protocol ninyo, sinasabi sa guidelines ninyo. So again, I would like to make it short. Tama ba yung sinasabi ko na ito ay, itong sulat na ito, opinion na ito, it covers the Iloto. Yun lang yun. Yes or no ka lang. Sabi mo kasi kanina, it is what it is. Meaning, kung ano yun nandyan, yun na nga yun. Kasi si Mr. Kua, yung chairman ng PCSO, he already gave his stand. Sinabi na niya na tama yung nakasulat dito at tumutugma doon sa sinasabi ko. So ngayon ikaw from OGCC. Kasi itong dokumento to galing sa inyo eh. Come on. Kung kinakailang hanggang madaling araw tayo na alas 12 rito, I won't mind. Promise. Comsec, mag-ready ka nga ng mga kubot-banig dyan. Hindi nga. gusto ko opinion ng OGCC kasi nakakuha ko na ng opinion mula sa PCSO from Chairman Juni Kua na sinasabing yung online loto, e-loto ay covered dito. Yun ang pagkakaintindi ko. Am I right, Mr. Kua? Para kunin ko ng opinion ng OGCC. Tama ba yung pagkabasa ko, Mr. Kua? Was it plain and simple? Na yung nakasulat dito, covered na yung e-loto.
Ang narinig ko ay yung patungkol sa paghingi ng approval ng OP.
Correct.
Tungkol diyan sa sa opinion ng OGCC.
Correct.
Kung ano man yung nakasaad diyan at kinonfirm ko lang na narinig ko yung binasa ninyo na kailangan ang OP approval.
So do you agree with me na dapat yung online or e-loto kailangan ng approval ng Office of the President per opinion given by OGCC. You agree?
Yun din po ang honest opinion ko.
Honest opinion. Thank you. Mm. Thank you. Now, it's your turn, Mr. Valle, Corporate Secretary.
Yes, Your Honor. So,
I call Corporate Attorney.
Thank you, Your Honor. So, this contract review pertains to the Memorandum of Agreement for the one-year test run of the web-based application betting platform executed by the PCSO and Pacific Online Systems Corporation. And I'm just reading from the contract review issued by the OGCC, Your Honor.
So, itong contract na ito, itong opinion na ito, na binigay, ulitin ko ulit sir, na binigay ng OGCC, does this cover yung e-loto na kailangan humingi, dapat humingi ng permiso from the OP? Simple lang po yung tanong ko, sir, na nahirapan po kayo. Kasi ang pagkakalam ko, lahat ng government-owned corporation, any kind of transaction they should enter into, any kind of entity, they should get the permission of the Office of the President. That's plain and simple. I'm not a lawyer, but I know that because I read some articles and I read some procedures, policies pertaining to that. And you are a lawyer and you don't know, and kailangan mo pa maghanap.
My apologies for that, Your Honor. I'd rather be careful because I don't want to mislead this, the Honorable Senator, Your Honor. But basically, based on my purpose...
No, we're not misleading anybody. Do not tayo sa dokumento. Stick with whatever is written in the document. In these documents. Di ba? Lawyer po kayo, di ba? Kung ano yung nakalagay dito, ganun man dapat pag mga lawyer, di ba? Stick to documents, wala dapat tayong mga hearsay, walang kulang, walang dagdag, walang bawas, di ba? Walang dagdag bawas. Kung ano yung nakasulat dito?
Basically, the opinion has 4 points, Your Honor. Number one, that the procurement of WABP pertaining to the Memorandum of Agreement that was given to me is within PCSO's mandate. Second, that the conduct of PCSO's games through the agent is imbued with public interest and that since this WABP...
No, sir. Lumalayo ka. Ang gusto ko lang po talaga... Meron na opinion po yung chairman. Ang gusto ko lang sabihin sa inyo dito, itong nakasulat, ang gusto ko lang malaman dito, malaman ng lahat, yung nakasulat po dito sa opinion ng OGCC, kasi kanina sinasabi ni Mr. Robles, two different games, birthday panalo and e-loto, at sinasabi niyang gaming platform versus e-loto. So, ang tanong ko lang po, sir, yung pong, ito lang po yung RI, basahin nyo lang. Yan lang yun, sir, yung RI. regarding sa first page and then sa page 5. Yun lang po yun, sir. Gusto ko lang makumpirma na yung nakalagay rito na opinion, nasa step 1 pa lang tayo, meron pa ako step 4. So haba tayo rito, sabi ko sa'yo, abutin tayo madaling araw dito, kung kinakailangan. Dito pa lang muna tayo sa una, regarding. Nais ko makuha ng inyong opinion naman, kasi kayo ang present dito, kayo ang pinadala. Ito po ay kinocover ang Iloto, na dapat ang Iloto kailangan ng permiso from the Office of the President.
Your Honor, under
maybe
paragraph
Corporate Secretary, 5. Next time, patawag natin yung mga signatories dito sa next hearing. I want them to be here. Okay, kasi itong pinadala nila, nagdidili-dali, nag-alanganin sa mga sagot niya. Go ahead po, Attorney Valle, sir. Attorney Del Valle.
Your Honor, under paragraph 5, page 23 of the contract review, 2404, it is PCSO was reminded that most importantly, the requirement under PCSO charter requiring prior approval from the Office of the President to undertake a mobile or online betting platform
Yon.
Should be observed, Your Honor.
Exactly. Thank you. Game over. Two opinions. Mr. Robles, na dapat humingi kayo ng permiso from the Office of the President. Now, meron kang binasa noon, sulat from the ES. Maaring ang legit yung sulat yan, although hindi ko nabasa. And I'm not gonna argue with you, hindi ko kukuntrahin yung sulat na pinadala sa'yo. Siguro, kaya nag-issue ng ganung sulat si ES, saying na okay lang. Now, you'll go ahead with that. Sapagkat, with that project, sapagkat hindi nyo pinakita to kay ES, itinago nyo ito, kasi kung pinakita nyo to kay ES, ES will say, hey, wait a minute. Magugas kamay siya. Ayokong gumawa ng kung anumang opinion na gusto niyong gawin ko, usulatin ko, sabihin ko. I'm not gonna do that because ayokong kontrahin ang OGCC. Magbabanggaan ang OGCC at saka ES. At I'm sure ES is a very smart person. Hindi siya magpapadalos-dalos. To his credit. Now, number two. 14% commission during the test. Number two, doon muna tayo sa you're only allowed 6 months. Pero pinilit yung gawing 1 year yung test run. Mr. Robles.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Ko na po, Mr. Robles. Dito, OGCC cited, while the determination of the experimental test run period of an online game rests upon the sound discretion of the PCSO board, it is noted that a period of 1 year may be already long enough to ascertain the operability, acceptability to the public, and economic and financial viability of the online game. Thus, it is recommended that the experimental test run period thereof be reduced from 1 year to 6 months, more or less. Sabi po ng OGCC dito, na dapat kung test run ang pinag-uusapan, 6 months lang. E ginawa niyo pong 1 year. At inilagay niyo po dito sa Memorandum of Agreement with Pacific Online. Again, that's another violation.
Your Honor, as you have said, we are in the best position as the same opinion cited. And Ito naman po ay is from the experience of the collective memory, the institutional memory of PCSO. So while it is a recommendation, the management of PCSO, those who have been here for more than 30 years, thinks otherwise, and that it should be taken as 1 year, Your Honor.
Yes, I understand. Again, Mr. Robles, hindi kita kontrahin dyan. Pinapalabas nyo, mas marami kayong kaalaman kaysa sa mga taga-OGCC. Okay? So yun ang pinapalabas mo. However, humingi kayo ng opinion sa OGCC, binigyan kayo ng opinion na hinihingi ninyo. Regardless, kasi kung kayo po mga eksperto dyan, then hindi na dapat kayo humingi ng opinion sa OGCC. Pag hindi kayo humingi ng opinion sa OGCC, then pag kayo pumalpak, mayayari kayo. But anyway, having said that, dito sinasabi ng OGCC, you must reduce the contract from the test run from 1 year to 6 months. They were asking you. Sana po, sinunod niyo yung request, yung hini-request sa inyo.
Mr. Chairman, hindi pa nga po nagsisimula yan, yung birthday panalo. That is pertaining again to birthday panalo.
No, tapos na po tayo sa birthday panalo. We're talking here of the Iloto po. Bumabalik po kayo doon sa napapakamot tuloy ng ulo si Mr. Ku. Kasi nga po, umiikot-ikot tayo rito. Pinaikot niyo po ako. Ayan, napapapakit. Na-stress na si Mr. Ku. Naputi na yung buhok niya. Mr. Ku, okay ka lang po, sir? Gusto niyo pong tubig?
Okay lang po. Meron naman akong tubig dito.
Okay. Ayoko naman po, sir. Magbumuka lang kayong dekorasyon dito. Parang flower base. Would you like to say something? Gusto niyo po, meron ba kayong gusto sabihin? Unless, kung gusto niyo, you want to remain silent?
Wala na po. At,
okay. So again, tatanungin ko na lang po kayo. Now, dito po, sa sinabi ng OGCC, the test, experimental test run period must be reduced from 1 year to 6 months. And they're referring dito sa Iloto. Hindi naman dito ni-refer nila yung birthday panalo. Am I right, Mr. Kuwa? Kasi so fully publicized itong Iloto, never. Wala nga nakaalam kung ano yung birthday panalo. I haven't heard of that birthday panalo. Second violation. Third violation. 14% commission. Okay. Ito po. Also contained in GOCC's opinion, stated, these game proponents should not receive any commission at all the sale and marketing of the online game tickets during the experimental test run of such games consistent with the objective of a mere test run except for recovery of actual reasonable cost. And you were further cautioned, this commission basis arrangement for the game proponents' sale and marketing of the online game tickets during the experimental test run period may expose members of the PCSO board and or PCSO's officers to criminal and or administrative liability under Section 3 of RA 3019 Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act for giving unwarranted benefits, advantage, or preference to a private party in the performance of its duties, if proven so, particularly during the test run, since new games will be given the chance to be launched without PCSO yet owning the system or patent to be used by the proponents. Despite the stern warnings by OGCC, in the memorandum of agreement for the 1 year test run period for web-based application being platformed between PCSO and Sweepstakes Office and Pacific Online System Corporation, you granted the proponent payment of commission, a 14% commission paid. Magkano po yung 14%, Mr. Robles? Magkano po yun, yung equals? Magkano inabot ng 14% commission na ibigay nyo so far dito po sa Pacific Online? Wala po kaming figures nun, sir. Mahirap kami mag-calculate. Magkano po inabot? So far po, magkano? Baka naman kasi sobrang laki na masyado.
As of January po, 2024, the total is 10,033,193 po.
193. Okay, as of January 15, 2024, 10,033,193. So therefore, inadmit nyo na kayo po ay nakatanggap na ng komisyon. 14%.
Hindi po kami tumatanggap ng komisyon, hindi po ako taga POSC.
No. Ang sinasabi nga po, dapat hindi po muna pinairal yung 14% commission.
Again, I hope, Mr. Chairman, we are reading from the same opinion. But nevertheless, yung pong may test run have their costs, no? Ano po? These are in the form of telecom cost, yung kanilang support po, yung cloud service subscription, yung maintenance cost and serving hosting cost po. These are all for the test po.
Okay, so this 14%, right? Sabi nyo, yung 19 million and change, yun ay para sa...
Wala pong 19 million, Mr. Church. Only 10 million. Wala pong 19 million.
Okay, sorry. 10,300,000. Okay, sorry sa writing ko. 10,033,193. Right? Ito yung 14% na sabi nyo so far. Yun yung tanong ko eh. Magkano yung equals ng 14%? Diba? Ito yung binigay yung figure so far. So, by stating that, you're admitting na meron ang 14% na tinatanggap mula sa Pacific Online.
And yung sabi mo lang, reimbursement ng cost nila, Your Honor.
Recovery ng cost nila.
Actually, if you would look at that, talagang minuscule pa po yan.
Yung 10,033,193, this is for the actual recovery cost. Pero hindi dapat 14%. Hindi dapat 14% ng kabuhang taya na pumasok sa online. Dapat magsiset aside ang Pacific kung magkano yung kanilang cost. Ito yung cost namin. Dapat they have a definite numbers. Kasi alam nila kung magkano yung nagagastos nila, magkano yung overhead nila. O itong total gastos namin, recovery namin, ito yung amount na ito. Hindi yung 14% ng total na taya. We're talking about 14% here. Eh.
Yes, Your Honor. That is the cap. Kasi kung pababayaan lang po natin sila mag-reimburse, kahit o anong gusto nila, hindi ko kami papayag. There must be a cap on the reimbursement. Kaya po we set a guideline na ganyan ng 14%. So, if I may, Your Honor, the
enumerated... So, what happens kung umabot ng 1 billion yung cap, yung 14%? No, I don't agree. Kasi, sabi mo yung may cap. Now, 14%, sabi mo, pinapayagan mo, igogo yung 14%. Eh, paano kung ang 14% sa dumating yung taya na sobrang laki, lumobo, at ang 14% ay 1 billion? That's just a possibility. That's just a number na I pick na could happen. Na sa sobrang daming tumaya sa online, umabot ang 14% na 1 billion, ibibigay mo pa rin yung 1 billion at yun yung naging gastos nila.
Mr. Chairman, we peg that, as you have seen now, from December 15 to January 15, ayan pa lang po ang sale ng 10 million, no? So, I don't know ano magiging, it's really hypothetical yung sinasabi nyo, pero we have to put a cap somewhere.
Then kailangan po lagyan natin ang cap. Dapat 14 million, dapat 5 million. O dapat, I mean, dapat hindi 14%, dapat 5%.
Well, kaya nga po eh, po ay within the operating expense din naman po under our charter, no? So, ayan naman po ay no cost sa amin. Kung matatandaan nyo, wala po kaming ginastos.
No cost nga sa inyo, pero some cost for the government. And the people na tumataya. Kasi nga po, 14, eto sir eh. Sinasabi nga dito na dapat hindi kayo tumatanggap ng 14% for the test run except, o nga, nandun na tayo, meron dito, except for recovery of actual reasonable cost. So wala naman sinasabi rito na for recovery of actual reasonable cost, wala sinasabi 14% eh. So kayo lang po nagbigay ng numbers. Okay? Kayo ang nagbigay ng numbers tayo, sabi mo para magkaroon ng cap. Now, sabi ko nga, paano kung umabot yung 14% ay more than 10 million at umabot ng 1 billion? Pagkalaki-laking cap.
Mr. Chairman, after
isa
one
pa, isa
year...
Pa po, isa pa po, may dagdag ko. What is prohibited is the commission system din. Prohibited po. Pinuprohibit yung commission system. You entered into this commission system by putting a cap of 14% nang galing po mismo sa inyo. That's still a commission, 14%.
Your Honor, that is a cap on the recovery. And after a year, we will purchase that if it works. If it works, we'll purchase. If it doesn't work, we're not going to purchase it.
Then it will not work. I'll make sure. Kasi, how sure are you, Mr. Robles? Kasi nagpasa ako ng batas na pinaharang ko itong online loto. Para bang nakakasiguro na kayo na hindi makakapasa itong batas na ito? How sure are you?
Your Honor, it's not within my...
You entered into a contract, one-year contract. What happens if in 6 months or less, naipasa ko ito at naging batas na ipinagbabawal yung iloto?
Then, Your Honor, the law will prevail.
Exactly.
You will be followed by all of us here, Your Honor.
And you know from the start na nagpapasa, meron akong batas tungkol dyan, pinushyo pa rin yung iloto.
Your Honor... Until your proposal is a law, we'll have to work. Kaya nga po, we respect that.
You know, you have to work, but there is an opinion from OGCC that states now you don't have to work on this kind of project unless you need to ask permission from the Office of the President, which you did not.
This is where we differ, your chair. Sa tingin namin, we're not on the same page. No, so...
Yan of course, we're not on the same page kasi ako'y nasa tama, kayo mukhang hindi.
Well, kaya nga po, nito we are cooperating with you. We also want you to see your law into fruition. Kami naman po ay tagapagpatupad lamang po. Ngayon, pag dumating po yung time na yan, rest assured, Your Honor, we will 100% comply with your law.
Well, no choice naman talaga kayo, Mr. Robles, FYI, pagbatas na yan. But anyway, from the very beginning, alam nyo naman po, yung stand ng committee na ito, wala kayo dito, hindi ata kayo umaten ng ilang beses ng hearing na ito. Sinabi ko na dito na yung aking marina pagtutol, kaya nga nagpasa po ako ng batas. Sana you should have taken the cue na okay, gagawa ng batas pala ang Senado tungkol dito, wag na lang siguro natin muna ituloy yung test run na yan. Yun po yung pinapoint out ko. I would like to acknowledge the presence of the minority leader, Senator Coco Pimentel. Senator Coco, good afternoon to you, sir. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, for inviting me and for calling this hearing.
Kanina pa kami nagkaroon ng discussion dito, so would you like to make an opening statement, Senator Coco?
Well, wala naman, Mr. Chairman, except that as a mathematician, I'm interested at looking at the rate of success in hitting the lotto jackpots, Mr. Chairman. And I will compare it with some other systems in some other countries, Mr. President.
Oh yeah. Anyway, nabuksan na rin lang yan. Meron pong nanalong isang tao sa 600, I think this the other day, 680 something million. Okay. Ang tanong ko po, yan ba yung sa online nanalo o yung sa betting station?
Over the counter po yan, yung sa traditional betting station. No, this is the yung una, yung 640 kayo naman. Relax lang. Kagabi yung iloto.
Hindi, sa iloto ba ito yung sa 600 something million? Sa
relax na, easy. We'll get there.
Sa iloto ba ito o yung sa Lotto agent station?
Last night po, Mr. Chair, it was 698 million. ang pinatinamaan po.
Kaya nga po, yung tumama na yon, saan po siya bumili ng ticket?
Sa Iloto po.
Sa Iloto. Good. Now, sa executive session, I need to know kung sino yung nanalo. Kasi nga po, merong mga balita na karating sa amin na katropa nyo na po yung nanalo. Totoo yan. Kaya ako na-brought up yan kasi in-open up ni Senator Coco yung tungkol sa mga pagpanalo-panalo na yan. So, mamaya mag-executive session tayo para masiguro na talagang hindi po katropa ninyo. Kasi yun po yung kumakalat na balita ngayon na hindi ko pinakinggan. Remember, hindi ko tinalaka yan until sa dumating si Senator Coco. So, kailangan ko yung pangalan, identity, nung nanalo. Especially sa Iloto pala siya nanalo. Kasi meron pong balita, 30 million na po ang ininvest ng tropa ninyo para manalo doon sa 690 million na yan. Tumatango si Ma'am Javier. Pero yan po ay, siyempre yan po yung sabi-sabi nila. Para maalis yung sabi-sabi na yan, mamaya po sa executive session, gusto ko malaman yung identity ng taong yan para makagawa kami ng mga research. Kung kinakailan, mag-hire ako ng private detective para masiguro na hindi connected sa tropa ninyo itong nanalo. Kapag halimbawa, after mag-hire ako ng private detective at na-trace na talagang, ay lumitaw na talagang hindi galing sa inyo, then sasabihin ko rito na yung ay chismis lamang, walang katotohanan. Pero pag lumitaw sa ginawang investigasyon, I might even use the NBI, DICT, private detectives, CIDG, lahat ng mga agencies ng gobyerno para gumawa ng cross-checking, LTO, PSA, kung connected ba o hindi, or SEC, connected ba o hindi sa mga kasamahan nyo dyan sa PCSO, itong nanalo. So mamaya sa executive session, Senator Coco.
Maganda po itong bill ninyo, Mr. Chairman, na na-file ninyo. Na, well, at any rate, Mr. Chairman, ilan na ba itong Lotto games na authorized by the PCSO? We have the big ones, the big ones. We have
the jackpot games are five, Mr. Chairman.
We have the 642, the 645, the 649, 655, and then the 658. Over the Christmas period, we increased the jackpots of all these five. Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Okay. Chairman.
For the 642 and the 645, 100 million. For the 649, 655, and 658, 500 million. One time. The plan was to do it one time. May we know the legal basis?
We are allowed to, we have a prize fund, Your Honor, prize fund reserve, and we are allowed to use this to spur the sales para magawin natin exciting and inviting yung game.
For each game, fixed na yung kanyang minimum jackpot eh. For every new draw, kung tinamaan yung jackpot, a new draw, balik siya sa minimum jackpot. So, that must have been fixed by mathematics. The probability of hitting 642 is, ilan ba, 1 in 9 million? Basta, okay, and then that's why it deserves a certain jackpot. So, when you made the jackpot, all of a sudden, 100 million, but the odds did not change, are you allowed by law to do that?
The board is allowed, your chair, Mr. Chairman. That's why we have the price fund reserve, precisely for this purpose.
How
the board to
add to the jackpot?
To add into the jackpot, yeah.
And then the decision was, one time, just to do it one time over that Christmas period of 2023.
Actually, ideally, Mr. Chair, it should be over the whole period of the year. Kasi every time may mananalo ka, you give in a prize fund reserve. Kasi minsan talaga, this is jackpot driven, Your Honor. People bet because of the jackpot. So kung mababa ho, medyo matamlay po. That is the time when you pump in the prize fund reserve.
What is the tenor of the board resolution that you will enhance the jackpot one time or?
One time po, yung ginawa namin for December so for one time. Okay. Because, Mr. Chair, at the end of the year, that will become dividend and will be reverted back anyway to the Bureau of the Treasury as dividend. So, might as well, we have decided to make the games more exciting.
Yeah, if you want to repeat this, you need to pass another resolution.
Yes, Your Honor, we have to go back to the board.
Basta klaro yan, okay. And then for the information of the public, yung mga increased jackpots po natin na 100, 100, 500, 500, 500, so a total of 1.7 billion pesos, tinamaan na po lahat.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, in less than a month.
Within a month, Your Honor.
Yes, within a month, tapo. Okay, so we were stating facts na, Mr. Chairman. Facts lang ito.
yun nga, Senator Coco, nakakapagtaka nga. Marami nagtataka, syempre, especially yung mga mananaya na ang bilis na manalo ngayon sa PCSO, especially na the fact na hindi naman pwedeng sabihin kung sino yung mga nanalo, pwede naman nila itago. Plus, pagdating po dun sa online, sila naman may control ng computer system na yan. So, madali na nilang i-hocus-pocus. Yun po yung sinasabing hinaing ng marami mga mananaya.
So, I think the PCSO is at liberty to reveal to us na yung in-increase na po yung mga jackpots, in all those games, available na yung online betting.
Yes, Your Honor.
Kaya, meaning to say, nung when si 642, all of, ang minimum niyan, and what's the usual minimum ni 642? Or maximum jackpot pala?
5.9.
Minimum ba?
5.9 po, Mr. Chair.
Bakit nalanganin? Hindi, yung publish.
Singit lang.
Ah, yes.
Okay. Yung sabi niyo, this December, tinamaan yung 642, 649, 645, 655, are these all from Iloto?
Hindi po, last night lang po yung Iloto.
Ilan po yung tumama sa Iloto out of this 1-2?
Isa lang po, yung kagabi lang po.
Kagabi lang.
Okay. What game yun? Yung kagabi?
655.
600 million kasi yun, Senator Coco. Quick na lang, Senator Coco. Okay. Etong picture na ito, very controversial ito ngayon sa social media. Edited daw ito.
Yes, Your Honor.
Edited. Bakit kailangan i-edit?
We have to protect the identity of the winner. Meron po nagreklamo sa amin one time, we covered the face, eh yung damit naman po, eh nakilala. So, nagreklamo siya, sana naman daw po, wag ipakita naman po yung damit. So, yan po ang reason niya, and I agree, it's a very poor editing, pero the objective is to conceal the clothing na ma-identify sa kanya.
So, ibig sabihin, so inamin nyo, in-edit to, pinalitan yung clothing.
Opo.
Bakit kinakailang palitan ang clothing?
Again, part po yan ng pag-conceal kasi na-identify po yung damit. For example, kung at that day, yung mga kapitbahay po, yun yung suit niya, ganyan. Or kung nakapag-selfie siya, meron yung pong nagreklamo sa amin, favorite clothes daw kasi, kaya nalaman siya. So, Your Honor, if there is something to apologize, it's the poor editing. But I think it has served its purpose of concealing the identity, Your Honor.
So at least inamin nyo, ayan, marami kasi mga nagtatanong, nagsabi, purang pagka-edit.
We're not very good at editing the clothes.
Pero yung tao hindi edited?
Ay, hindi po, totoo
po yan. Tunay na tao to?
Tunay na tao po yan.
Okay, so kaya sabi ko mamaya sa executive session, gusto ko malaman yung identity ng itong taong to, pati yung nanalo sa 690 million.
Actually, sure lahat po on record yan, kung isusupinan nyo po, we can provide the names.
No, sa executive session, pwede naman siguro yan. Am I right, Senator Coco? Can we do that on executive session?
Yes, Mr. Chairman, let's make it a strictly executive session.
Yes.
Given on the part of the Senate, limitado yung mag-a-attend at saka identified natin. And then, of course, kami, liability na namin yung kami pang source ng leakage. So.
Like I said, Mr. Robles, kasi nga po, may clamor na malaman yung katotohanan. Kasi marami sa mga mananay nagsasabi, yung nanalo ng 690 million, hindi raw yung legit na mananaya, kundi galing doon sa tropa niya. I'm sorry, I'm gonna repeat this again. Yung pong kumakalat na balita, galing doon sa tropa niyo, nag-invest ng 30 million para makuha nga itong 690 million. Para maalis na po yung haka-haka na yan, gusto po namin makita kung talagang totoong tao yon. And then gagawa nga ako ng cross-checking. Sinabi ko na kanina, I'm gonna use the NBI, the ICT, if I have to hire a public private detective para magkaroon ng cross-checking kung yun ba related sa inyo. Hindi. Pag lumitaw na hindi, sabihin ko rito na hindi related talagang legit winner niya. You agree, sir? Very good. Okay, Senator Coco, meron kayong gustong idagdag. Siguro, bumalik tayo ngayon dun sa komisyon na 14% na sinasabi in the first place, bawal yung komisyon. Now, sabi nyo, hindi naman naglagay kayo ng cap na 14% dahil kailangan magkaroon nga ng cap. Dapat, hindi nyo kinonsider that as commission. Very explicit po kasi na bawal ang komisyon. Now, ang sinasabi nyo, hindi po komisyon kasi nga po, yun ay para i-recover yung mga gastos, etc. Pero sa contract po, sir, lumilito po na yun ay payment as commission, yung 10 million. Ito po, payment of sa 13. Sa number 13 po, payment of commission, a 14% commission shall be paid to the agent based on the generated daily sales. Oh, you entered into a contract stating na magkakaroon ng payment of commission na 14% doon sa testing, na sinasabi naman po ng OGCC hindi dapat during the testing period there's no such thing as commissions that must be given, that should be given. Sinabi po ng OGCC na no can do para sa commission, wala dapat commission pag-uusapan during the testing period. And yet dito po sa kontrata sinabi ninyo na magbabayad kayo ng 14% ng PCSO commission sa Pacific Online. So again, that's a violation of the law. And this is tantamount to graft and corruption, sir. I don't know, maaaring hindi po kayo makakasuhan dito. Maaaring mga kasamahan po ninyo pwede makasuhan dito ng graft and corruption. Kung sino man po mga pumirma dito, sino man po ang nag-instigate ng nitong kontratang ito. Graft and corruption po, maliwanag pa sikat ng araw. Ito pong kontratan to. Dami pong butas.
Mr. Chairman, if I may.
Yes, sir.
I think the guidance is for us to have a reasonable cost. So we will have to determine din talaga yung reasonableness ng cost nila. But as I've said, we're putting a cap on that.
I understand, sir. I understand. Sana po, hindi nyo po sinabi dito sa contract, payment of commission. Sana nilagay nyo payment of recovery. There's a big difference between payment of recovery and payment of commission. Yung payment of recovery, hindi po bawal yun. Trust me, hindi po bawal. Pero yung payment of commission, bawal po yun. That's tantamount to graft and corruption. Ito po, very clear, oh. Number 13, payment of commission. Na bawal dapat, during test run, there's no such thing as commission being paid. Di ba, sir? Maaring nga sabi ko, maaring hindi ikaw makakasuhan dito. Pero yung mga kasamahan mo, maliwanag pa sa sikat na araw na may kaso pong graft and corruption. Attorney Francis Julius Romeo Del Valle, ano sa tingin mo? let's talk about 14% commission. Huwag ka na magpaliguligoy pa, sir. Straight to the point po.
Yes, Your Honor, if I may, as stated in the OGCC opinion, the PCSO may not charge any commission, may not receive any consideration or commission except for reasonable or recovery of reasonable costs.
Exactly. So therefore, dito dapat sa kontrata nakalagay payment of recovery, not payment of commission. You agree, attorney? Sir,
if PCSO can justify that 14% constitute reasonable costs, then that's the...
No, sir. I'm talking about what's stated in the contract. Come on. Sir, lawyer ka, di po ba? Alright. There's a big difference between payment for recovery and payment commission. Yung payment for recovery, wala tayong problema doon. Kasi pinapayagan naman yun. Pero yung payment of commission, hindi po pinapayagan yun. Pero nilagay nila dito sa contract na dapat in the first place wala sa kontrata to. Yung paglagay nila doon sa kontrata nitong payment commission, may violation agad, sir. Do you agree as a lawyer?
Your Honor, subject to the rules and regulations of the Commission on Audit to audit the commission to be received by the PCSO, I submit that that commission is okay. Not allowed based on the
Okay.
Based on the contract review.
Yes, thank you. So therefore, sana hindi nilagay niyo dito, Mr. Robles, na payment of commission kasi binabawal naman talaga. Ayan, sinabi na ni Attorney De Valle. Sana nilagay niyo payment of recovery regardless kung yan ay 15 million, 20 million. Wala kang violation doon. Kasi sabi mo, okay, 50 million binayad namin for the recovery. Eh, yun talaga yung amount ng recovery. Magpakita ng resibo para pagdating sa commission ng audit, babanggain, oh, talagang 50 million ang ginastos nyo. Hindi mo na kailan ng kap-kap. Pero the fact na nilagay nyo dito payment of commission, tapos 14%, tumutugma pa kung sa anong nakalagay dito, tinugma nyo, nagbigay ka ng 14% sa sales. So, again, violation na naman yan, Mr. Robles. Ayan na, nagsalita na, oh. Yung lawyer ng
Mr. Chair, una kasi yung contract before the review. So, that one was made before the review. So, while we're at the testing stage, we will adjust that according to the reasonableness of the,
Yes, of the, but before you entered into a contract with any entity, okay, you should have obtained permission from the Office of the President, and you did ask for the opinion of OGCC, and OGCC gave you this opinion, and yet hindi nyo sinunod yung sinabi ng OGCC. Ba't pa kayo humingi ng opinion kung hindi nyo susundin?
Mr. Chair, the contract kasi, as I've said, came before the review. Otherwise, they would not be reviewing anything. So we
kaya nga po, sir, before sana po kayo nag-enter into a contract. Yung po yung patakaran eh. You should know the drill. You know the protocol. Bago kayo mag-enter into a contract with any entity whatsoever, being a government-owned corporation, there must be an opinion coming from OGCC bago kayo gumawa ng anumang hakbang. Sana may permiso. Kasi yung pong sinasabi ng OGCC, may permiso sa Office of the President. At sana may permiso kayo. Sana meron kayong hiningin opinion sa OGCC. Kasi kung humingin kayo ng opinion sa OGCC prior to this contract, hindi na sana itong 13 na ilagay dito. Kasi kung pumunta po kayo sa OGCC, OGCC, magkakaroon po kami ng contract ha, with Pacific. At kami po ay magbibigay ng komisyon. Sinabi ng OGCC, hindi pwede, bawal yan. O di wala na sana ang number 13 dito, payment of commission. Sana nakalagay na rito, payment of para maliwanag at wala kayong sabit, payment of recovery. Wala tayong problema sa payment of recovery. Mr. Robles, maski na sabi mo pa, 50 million payment of recovery, wala tayong makita problema. As long as, sabi ko kanina, magpakita lang pagdating sa auditing ng Commission of Audit na talagang 50 million, maski na 100 million pa yan kung talagang yun ang tamang amount for the recovery of the expenses incurred as a result pag puputap ng online system ng Pacific para sa Iloto.
Mr. Chairman, we have the Memorandum Circular of 2023-08. Ito po yung post-execution review of contracts. So, nakalagay po ron, pwedeng pagkatapos po ma-execute, tsaka po i-review. This is exactly what happened here, Mr. Chair.
Okay. August 19, 2023 po, nag-release ng opinion regarding Iloto ang OGCC. Mr. Del Valle, Attorney Del Valle, you follow me? Are you following me, sir? August 19, 2023, right? You have that on record, sir? Look it up. August 19, 2023, OGCC released their opinion on the Iloto launch. August 30, napirmahan po yung Memorandum of Agreement. So you have 19, wait a minute, sorry. April 19, 2023. I'll take it back kanina yung sinabi ko August. April 19, 2023. Nag-release ng opinion ang OGCC pertaining to Iloto. Attorney Del Valle, look it up please, sir. April 19, 2023. And then August 30, 2023, nagkaroon ng signing Memorandum of Agreement between PCSO and Pacific Online System. April, May, June, July, August, 4 months. Attorney Del Valle, tama ba? April 19, 2023, nagbigay kayo ng opinion. Kayo dyan sa OGCC, tama?
Yes, Your Honor. Opinion number 70.
Exactly. And then, meron silang 4 months para i-correct yung kanilang ilalagay dito sa contract na sinabi ng OGCC kung ano yung mga bawal. And yet, hindi sinunod. Pinagpatuloy yung mga bawal. At after 4 months, nagkaroon ng pirmahan at in-include pa rin kung ano yung mga binabawal ng OGCC. Am I right, Attorney Del Valle, sir?
Your Honor, if I may, based on the opinion number 70 of the OGCC regarding the conduct of the online betting platform. It says that PCSO should first issue guidelines with regard to the launching of this online game proposal. So it does not categorically say, at least this opinion does not categorically say that online betting platforms should not be allowed. Instead, it mandated PCSO to issue the necessary guidelines and rules that will provide for the parameters.
I understand. I understand. Precisely. Correct. You're right. We're talking here about the commission, Attorney Del Valle, sa number 13, sa Memorandum of Agreement, which says payment of commission. Na sinasabi po ng OGCC, bawal ang commission sa during test run. Ang sinasabi kasi ni Mr. Robles, late, nauna pa yung contract. Ang sinasabi ko naman, base dito sa timeline, meron silang 4 months para baguhin yung kanilang guidelines. Tama ka, mag-issue ng guidelines. Whatever those guidelines are, dapat hindi kasama doon yung payment of commission. Kasi nga po, sinasabi ng OGCC, bawal yung commission. Am I right, Attorney Devalier? Am I not confusing you or you're the one confused?
Your Honor, if I may, under this same contract review, opinion number 70 rather, page 10, the commission, it reads that this commission basis arrangement for the game proponent sale and marketing of the online game tickets during the experimental test run period may expose liability, and also that basically that the commission is not allowed under the test run.
Exactly. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Attorney Coco, may gusto kayong sabihin?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Itong page 5 of the Memorandum of Agreement, paragraph 13, commission 14% shall be paid to the agent. Who is the agent, Mr. Robles?
POSC, Your Honor.
Pacific Online Systems Corporation. Okay, so when they entered into this agreement, did they demand that the jackpot be augmented?
No, Your Honor.
Hindi na, di ba? So meaning to say, when they made their pencil pushing, nagka-compute-compute sila, pirma pa rin sila sa Memorandum of Agreement even though the jackpot remained the normal jackpot. Is that correct? Into the mic, sir.
Yes, sir. Well, this yung jackpot na increase namin was only in December. We did so in yung anniversary namin. Wala pa rin yung iloto. In October 30, we made everything 89 million in celebration of our 89 years.
Pero walang ayun. Itong payment of commission did not wasn't still there nung
wala pa po yun. December po yun.
Pero itong augmentation ng jackpot sa last December covered na nitong payment of commission yung sales noon, tama?
Well, the timing, yes. It was December 16.
Yes. Pasok na. Covered na ng Memorandum of Agreement na to. So, if the PCSO board augmented the jackpot and it boosted the sales, the commission of Pacific Online Systems Corporation also got boosted. Tama?
Well, it is based on their sales, but this is all based on sales, including the traditional, Your Honor, in everything. Correct. When the pot is increased, everybody gains from it.
Correct. Basta nung hindi binoost ang jackpot, mayroong sales dyan, 14% ng sales goes to POSC as commission, per contract. Per contract, page 5 ng number 13, payment of commission. A 14% commission shall be paid to the agent based on the generated daily sales.
Only on the e-lotto, Your Honor.
Which are what games?
All the games.
Correct.
Your
That's
Honor.
The 642, 645, 649, 655, and 658. Tama. Are these all the e-lotto? Are these all the jackpot lotto games with e-lotto?
Yes, Your Honor, correct. Because it's a payment platform.
Correct, kaya nga. And these are the 5 lotto games where we augmented the jackpot prices. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor. Right.
And the purpose was to generate more sales. Tama?
Yes, correct. on all betting platforms, including the traditional.
Correct. Including the traditional, yes. Okay. But when Pacific Online Systems Corporation entered into this contract, this MOA, there was no agreement, no demand, and no commitment for PCSO to augment the jackpots.
None, Your Honor.
None, di ba? Okay. So when you augmented the jackpots and generated more sales through the payment platform of online, we also helped the Pacific Online Systems Corporation, because we also increased their commission way beyond their original projections na using the normal jackpots, the non-augmented normal jackpots.
We were looking, Your Honor, at increasing sales in general, which it did, Your Honor. There was nothing about in consideration of Pacific Online. That's a natural consequence, Your Honor.
Yes, oh, tama. Basta they did not ask for this, naisip lang ninyo to generate sales. And the consequential benefit na lang sa Pacific Online Systems yon because of this provision on commission on the generated sales, 14%.
Yes, Your Honor. Because remember, in the anniversary ng PCSO, we increased the jackpot and it was well received by the people. This is wala pa kahit yung POSC online iloto. Wala pa nun. And that was very encouraging. That prompted us to increase the jackpot, Your Honor.
Yes, anyway, but that's previous to this. Eh. Wala pa nitong mawa. We're looking at this one. Itong mawa lang na ito. So, okay, the augmentation of the jackpot, which came as a surprise maybe also to Pacific Online Systems Corporation, kasi I'm sure nung nag-negotiate kayo nitong kontratang ito, the jackpots that they had in mind when they were computing their the economic viability of the contract were the normal jackpots. Tama yun? Tama. Normal jackpots.
I wouldn't know. That would be their own strategy.
Right. The normal jackpots, because wala namang may alam that you would augment it to 100, 100, 500, 500, 500. So, ganun po ang nangyari. So, my point, Mr. Chairman, is because of this augmentation by the board, then more sales were generated, and because of this Section 13, Payment of Commission section, there was also a consequential benefit to the agent, Mr. Chairman.
That is correct.
Just an observation, Mr. Chairman.
So, mababalik tayo doon again, Mr. Robles. Ayan, nagsalita na kanina si Attorney Romeo Del Valle na sana wala itong payment of commission. Hindi sana nilagay ito sa kontrata. Sana ang nilagay nyo na lang payment for the recovery of the expenses, etc., etc. So, wala kayong violation, wala kayong problema. Meron kayong 4 months na para baguhin from April to August. Baguhin yung entry nyo rito sa kontrata, but you did not. You insisted on the commission. Yun po yung problema rito. Attorney Robles, again, ulitin ko for the end time, maaaring hindi ngayon kumakasuan dito, maaaring wala ka talaga, inosente ka talaga rito. Pero yung mga alipores mo, may kaso rito. Trust me. Meron. Graft and Corruption Practices Act. Doon sa violation na yan. Dahil nagpadalos-dalos po, pinilit, minadali, may labas ng kontrata, which is only in favor of Pacific Online, injurious doon naman sa gobyerno. Ayan po, nagsalita na po si Attorney Del Valle. Sige po, ayan, hindi po kayo sumasagot, parang nag-agike na meron talagang problema. Balik tayo dito kay Miss Evelyn Javier, kasi naawa ako sa napakaraming na-displace ng mga lotto agents yung sa mga betting stations. So, ma'am, itong 2,000 na nawalan po ng trabaho, nawalan po ng negosyo, ano po yung kanilang hinain ngayon?
Gusto lang namin po sanang hilingin kay GM at sa kay Chairman na yung mga na-displaced po eh, hayaan po nila na makapagbukas muli. At kung pwede po, sana na maka-order na sila ng mga machine para makapagbukas sila or i-prioritize po na mabuksan sila, lalo na po yung sa Mindanao po at saka sa Visayas, kasi sila po yung pinakamaraming nasarado. Okay. Hindi naman po kami nilalabanan po yung kasi kakampi naman po naman talaga namin ang PCS. So dahil yan po yung pinili namin na hanap buhay. Nakakaawa lang po dahil una ho yung nirason ay low sales, tapos yung pala po wala yung machine. Umaasa pa po, dyan po yung mga iba, galing sila po ng mga iba-ibang probinsya. Nakaramihan po dyan ay displaced at saka may mga tellers din po yata na sumali na nawalan po ng trabaho. Kaya kawawa naman po sila, dumaan po yung Pasko, wala ho silang kabuhayan.
Okay. Well, binanggit niya po, Chairman, yung panawagan sa inyo, ano pong reaksyon niyo? Na sana rin po, may balik at mabigyan ng machines yung 2,000 ng mga na-displace, ng mga lotto agents. Ano pong reaksyon niyo, being the chairman of PCSO? Yung panawagan nila sa inyo. And then later on, si GM Robles.
Well, narito naman po yung aking mga kasama sa PCSO, pati na management. Siguro, para sa akin, personal, makailangan pag-aralan. pag-aralan kung paano ma-address yung concern ng mahigit 2,000 na naapektuhan. But of course, this is a collective decision-making body. Pagkakasunduan po namin kung ano ang magandang gawin sa hinaing ng Polay. And sa aking pananaw po ay kailangan din pakinggan at bigyan ng lunas.
Okay, when you say kailangan pakinggan at bigyan ng lunas, meaning we have to come up with a solution para mabigyan ng action ang kanilang problema.
Tama po yun. Nakikinig naman po ang management.
Right. At ang kanilang problema ay sana may balik sila sa trabaho at mabigyan ng mga machines. Am I right? Yun pong gusto mangyari.
Opo. So, nandiyan naman po ang management. Nakikinig.
So, would you encourage the management na pakinggan itong hinaing ng mga taga-Polay, sir, as chairman?
Ano po?
Para sa inyo po, kailangan bang pakinggan ng management itong mga hinaing ng mga taga-Polay, mga membro, especially?
Opo, nandito naman po sila. Napakinggan nila yung mga hinaing at mapag-aralan kung ano ang pwede maging lunas na pwede i-recommenda sa board at ma-actionan collectively.
Ms. Abir, ma'am.
Ang isa pa ho po sa pinakamabigat po naming problema eh, tinanggal po yung cancellation ng machine. Minsan po nagkakamali po yung ating mga mananayo or minsan madumi po yung card. Minsan po binabasa niya kahit 100 po yung taya, lumalabas po ng 1,200. Eh, hindi na po pwedeng makansela. So, ang nagsasuffer po talaga ay yung mga agents po at mga tellers. Kaya yung mga tellers po namin halos ayaw na hong magtrabaho kasi araw-araw po meron silang nakakansela. Binalik na po, dati po tinanggal po yan pero nung dating administrasyon, tapos na-realize po nila na talagang kawawa po yung mga agents at saka mga tellers pag tinanggal po yung ano yung cancellation. Kaya inire-request po namin kay GM po at sa kay chairman na kung pwede naman po eh wag naman pong na maibalik po yung ano yung cancellation at saka wag naman po sanang maging masyadong stricto po sa amin kasi kami naman po panghabang buhay ang karamihan po ng mga agents dito mga pioneer po mga 30 years na po yung ako 20 years na po ngayon lang po masyadong naging mahigpit po yung ano.
Okay, let me interrupt you on that, Ms. Javier. So, ano pong dahilan yung nung kanilang pagiging sobrang higpit? Does it, yung ba ay sapagkat na nalulugi ang PCSO?
Ano po sa inyo palagay? Ayoko naman po sanang ano, pero ang sinasabi po ng karamihan po ng mga agents.
Is it because loss of revenue para sa PCSO kaya naghigpit sila or po, naghigpit sila for another reason?
Gusto po raw nila na masarado na lahat ng mga loto. Kasi yun, masyadong very strict na po talaga yung parang mga memo po na lumalabas. Kasi dati wala naman.
So, naging strict to kuminsa kahit wala sa lugar. Is that what you're trying to say?
Well, yun po yung
para mawala na kayo?
Pagkakaintindi po ng karamihan dito ng mga agents po na parang nagigipit po kami masyado. Actually, ako po, wala naman po akong problema kasi nagko-comply po ako sa sumusunod po kami sa pagde-deposit araw-araw at nagbubukas naman po kami ng ano, na alas 7 hanggat alas 8 po ng ano, hanggat 8:30 po ng gabi. Pero dun sa mga ibang probinsya po kasi, hindi naman po sila makakomply dun sa 7 o'clock hanggat 8:30 kasi minsan po, 5 o'clock pa lang, wala na pong mga tumataya sa kanila tapos i-demand po ng kanilang mga branches na kailangan bukas sila. So, hindi po namin maintindihan kung ba't nagkaganon po yung nangyari.
So, meron palang patakaran na kailangan yung outlet ay open until 8 o'clock?
Opo, 7 o'clock to
7 to 8:30. Kahit na alam nila, especially doon sa mga lugar na mga liblib, alam nila na wala naman na ay after 5 o'clock, pinipilit pa rin. Kapag hindi ka sumunod doon sa request nila, makakansila ka.
Pwede po kung kaming ano, mablock or
mablock
for termination.
Mr. Robles.
Well, kung maaari po, gusto ko pong talakayin yung cancellation. We learned na yung cancellation po, ayan po yung tumaya. Tapos, sasabihin, ay, canceled pala. So, nabigyan na ng ticket, tapos ika-cancel. Okay. Alam niyo po kung magkano it's costing us? 500,000 to 600,000 a day cost of cancellation. At ito po ang nakita namin, that in fact, in one branch, sa tinignan namin yung top 10, mas marami po yung cancellation sa actual transaction, which is we find it strange. Bakit mas marami yung cancellation sa actual sale? So, hindi po nangyayari yun. 14,000, for example, in one case, there was 14,000 cancellations. Yung sale niya ay 9,000. So, ano ba yun? Doon pumunta yung tao, tumaya, tapos ay mali, tapos walked away. So, it's very unnatural. So, okay. Hindi po ganun ang psychology na mananaya. And this doesn't happen across the board. Selected po outlets na nangyayari yan. So,
Mr. Robles, anong reason para sa inyo? Siyempre, gumawa kayo ng research siguro niya, pag-imbestiga. So, ano ang reason, based on the result of your investigation, bakit nagkakaroon ng cancellation?
Nasa level po ng possibly sa teller, umalis. Kasi po merong winning cancel ticket . Meron po kaming ganong case. Ibig sabihin, akala ng mananaya, good yung ticket niya. Yung pala kinancel na. So, magka-claim siya ngayon, makikita cancel ticket mo. So, anong gagawin niya? Babalik siya dun sa pinagbilan niya, which babayar naman. Ang tawag po doon, linalabanan yung PCSO. Kasi 4,500 lang naman. Nangyayari po ito, you'll be surprised, nangyayari lang po ito sa 2D and 3D, and most likely 2D, kasi mababa lang po yung premyo . So, pwedeng labanan na. Kumbaga, bahala na. Kapag nanalo, di bayaran. Pag hindi nanalo, di kanila yon. Yun ho ang findings namin dyan. So, yan po, tinigil namin. At hindi po across the board, buti kung lima dito and all over, hindi po gano'n nangyayari. So we have to act on that. And true enough, we saved dun sa cancellation dahil tinigil na nga po namin . So, ayan po ang dahilan yan. At hindi naman po kami nag-accuse. We have the data kung sino po yung mga top natural cancellation. Can you imagine they outnumber the actual sales? Paano naman po nangyari yun? Tapos ano yun? Hindi na natuto, lagi na lang nakakancel. No? Ano yun? Lagi na lang siya nagkakamali. Eh, siya ho ang sumusulat dun sa bet slip yung tao. Siya ho ang sumusulat ng taya niya. Bakit ho nagkakamali? Kung siya naman ho ang sumusulat nun. No? So, hindi ho accurate yan. At kami po ay supported by data and hindi po namin aalisin for the record ang ating over-the-counter. Hindi po yan ang tamang pagpapalaro niyan. You have to increase jackpot para ho gumanda ang sales. Ako po ang nagsuggest nung sinasabi niya, gamitin yung lumang system. Ay, kaya lang po, that is a 25-year-old machine. Ayaw na rin po mag-integrate nung bago. Dahil paano nga naman i-integrate yung 25-year-old system? It will be very costly.
Now, why not give them new machines?
Sir, matagal po ang ordering ng machine po. It will take you almost a year. And then the cost, sa additional cost po, hindi po recoverable. I'm sorry, hindi po ako nag-negotiate ng unang price noon. But tinitingnan po namin, paano namin marirecoup if it's very expensive? Okay. Yan po ang reason namin, sa management decision. Don't worry sir, we're looking for other ways, even cheaper ways of putting up a system. Kasi po, kung malalaman nyo, pareho lang yan ang online .
Teka muna sir, sino yung tumatas ng kamay kanina?
Yes,
ma'am, can we... Are you lotto operator, lotto agent? Ano po? Teller. Okay. Sige. I would like to hear a reply from a teller. Pwede ba natin sila isa lang at state your name please? Tungkol doon sa tinatawag na cancellation. So being a teller, so meron kang alam.
Good afternoon po. Ako po si Zinaida Salvador. 23 years lotto teller.
Okay, saan po kay Lotto Taylor, ma'am?
Makati po.
Sa Makati. Okay. Nagsalita kanina si Mr. Robles tungkol
sir,
sa cancellation.
Yung mga previous years, meron po nangyaring ganyan kasi mismo ako yung nakita noon. Yung isang checker sa accounting, nakita nga na meron parang ganun na nagka-cancel pero yung naka-insert na ticket sa ilalim is not good ticket. Ngayon, ang problema po namin, hindi naman po lahat. Ilan ang mga lotto outlets? Kumbaga, okay. Dapat hindi nila lahat.
So, you admit na meron talagang ganun?
Meron na nangyari noon. Matagal na yun . Mga nasa alam ko na sa ano pa yun kami, Quezon City.
How long was it, ma'am? Ilan taon na nakaraan?
2005, 2007, I think ganun.
So after 2005, wala na kayo alam na nangyari?
Ay, wala na akong narinig. Ano pero sabi nila, meron daw din pang nangyayari, may nagre-reklamo pa. Okay. Ngayon, ang ano ko lang po, hindi naman po lahat ng tellers ganun. Kumbaga, marami po kami. Kung lalahatin, katulad niyan, meron ako na, naranasan ko yun eh, 240. Ang sahod ko, 400, minus 240. Diba? Ano na mangyayari? Bali, ang machine po ngayon, napaka-sensitive. Tapos meron pong mga, ano, minsan may mga errors po na hindi namin kaya. Hindi namin kayang anuhin eh. Kumbaga wala kaming...
Beyond your control.
O wala kaming control doon. Katulad yung sa mga printer error, sa mga thermals, yung mga scanner error. Ang... Ewan ko kung alam na nila yun, yung loob ng glass cleaner, pag yun nalagyan ng alikabok. Pag once nagpasok ka ng card, pag akyat ng alikabok, babasahin yung kung saan siya tumapat. Ganon minsan ang nangyayari doon sa mga ticket na binabasa ng ibang amount.
Okay. And because of that, nagkakaroon ng cancellation.
Opo.
I mean, kayo ay, yung sinasabi kanina ni Ms. Javier, hinigpitan hanggang sa ma-terminate.
Kayo sa kontrata. Nung nagtanong naman po ako nung nakaraan sa accounts, tinanong ko po yan. Ang sagot sa akin ay, yung one day po na, ay yung kumbaga pag lagi na lang daw nagka-cancel, yung sa cancellation naman po, medyo hindi naman sila, kumbaga, kami yung magsasuffer.
Sa cancellation kayo po magsasuffer?
Oo, magsasuffer.
Na ibabawas po sa sweldo nyo?
Bawas sa amin yun. Kasi hindi rin naman ikikerry lahat ng ano na ng agent eh. Katulad nun, meron akong, kasi may mga GCs po ako ng mga tellers. Meron doon, 6,700 inabunuhan niya.
Hmm.
Meron 1,002. May mga records po ako nun. May mga, yun nga po eh, ang hirap po doon sa mga, yung printer error, yun ang hindi namin kaya. Pero yung kunyari, nagmamanual lang kami, magkakamali kami. Pwede namin sagutin yun. Pero yung mga printer error, yung mga thermal error, ang hirap eh, hindi namin control. Wala kaming control doon eh.
Okay.
So, 23 years po akong teller, pero ngayon lang ako nakaranas ng ganyang kalalaking ano.
So, Mr. Robles, away kayo doon. Yung sinasabi po ni Ms. Salvador.
Yung mga bago-bago po yung ating PLS at we have referred the matter to them at yung pong mga sinasite namin po ay nakadokumento po which prompted us. Yun pong sinasabi nyo ay we will have to look into yung isolated cases na yun. Pero ang nakita namin talaga without even checking yung maliliit po, yung wholesale cancellation po. Yung po ang meron po namin nakita. We got the top 10. Tapos, nangyayari lang po yung cancellation sa 2D and 3D lang po.
No
kung,
po.
It's arguable. Pero yung pong tinignan namin, ang majority po lang, nakita nyo 6 digits, hindi nagkakamali. Meron po yun eh. Yung tinignan namin, bakit ka nagkakamali sa 2D and 3D? Sa 6D, hindi ka nagkakamali. Wala ho. 0 on 2D, 3D. Kasi humalaki ho ang premyo ng 6D. Hindi ho kayang labanan yon. Yun ho ang naging explanation over the years. So yun ho talaga ang naging reason namin. Yung mga, kita nyo, 14,000 yung cancellation, 9,000 yung pumasok. E, paano naman ho yun? So yun ho, indicative na yun eh, na yung 4D tsaka 6D hindi nagkakamali. E, bakit doon namumukod tangi lang ho, doon sa 2D and 3D?
Ms. Javier?
GM, may we suggest po na yung mga grabe po yung cancellation, di dapat po yun sila ang tiniterminate at saka po, sila na lang po yung binablock, pero wag naman po yung lahat, kasi yung mga iba naman po talaga, kami ho, takot at takot kami ngayon mag-cancel po. Ihilingin na lang po namin sana na kung may kasalanan po yung isang agent, dapat po ipatawag siya kasi nagsasuffer po yung karamihan dahil po dun sa kanilang kasalanan.
Tama, I agree with that, Mr. Robles. So, yung sabi nyo kanina, identified nyo, yun din daw yung sabi mo yung lugar at mga lotto agents na palaging nagkakaroon ng cancellation. Then, yun dapat ang ipatatawag nyo, yun dapat ang i-terminate nyo yung kanilang kontrata. Bakit yung 2,000 na damay?
Hmm. Ito po, sample.
Ma'am.
Sample.
May sample. Ano po yung sample nyo, ma'am? Hmm. Ano po ito, ma'am?
Sample po yan ng mga tickets na hindi namin makancel kasi nga...
Punit dahil sa thermal.
Dahil nga po sa ano, yung walang cancellation, eh, ang problema po dyan sa scanner.
Scanner, okay. Yes, kung maintindihan ito, alam ba ba?
Yung ang taya, sa 310, ang taya lang dyan is 10 pesos, nagiging siyang 310. Binabasa po yung, wala naman siyang nakaguhit, pero binabasa yung 300.
Ah.
Ganun po. So, ito po naman yung sa scanner.
So, scanner ang ito, may problema.
Oh.
So, kunyari, ang taya mo is... magkano ulit ang taya?
Ang taya ay 10 pesos lang. 10 pesos? Diba? Dalawang 10 yan. Yung isa naging 300.
Okay, dalawang 10.
Opo.
Hindi, 210 yung isa.
Opo. Ay, balig, ano po, parang may binasa siyang isang 300, isang 200. Ito naman po yung sa printer error. Ay, sa thermal error. Printer error din, kasama na sa thermal.
Okay.
Na ayaw tanggapin ng customer kasi punit. Pero good ticket naman sana siya. Kaso lang punit, hindi tinatanggap ng customer.
Bakit na po na punit?
Sa thermal po.
Sa thermal?
Yung mga thermal po
kasi... Kahit na siguro ako mananaya, pag nakita ko punit, huwag ko tanggapin yan. Eh baka mamaya, pag nanalo yung ticket ko, eh mga babahin valid. So, again, eh maging cancellation
yan. Ay, sagot na namin. Kumbaga, babayaran
na. Kakainin nyo na yun?
Hmm. Laban na lang.
Yan ang mga legit na cancellation.
Hmm.
So, maraming dahilan. Yung sinasabi niyo po, naiintindihan ko kayo, Mr. Robles, may mga gustong rumakit, gustong labanan, nagigirila kung tawagin, against PCSO. Okay, legit yun. Dapat yun ang mga parusahan. Huwag yung mga talagang honest to goodness na pagkakamali na saka, hindi nila beyond their control. Tulad nun yung...
Tsaka po, ano, yung kumbaga bigla kasing nagkaroon ng cancellation, wala man lang... leeway na pwede kami tumawag. Kunyari, may cancel kaming malaki. Pwede sana namin itawag sa hotline. Kahit pagtawag sa hotline, wala eh.
Makorek.
Wala
eh. Okay. Ayun, binigyan sana silang leeway o pagkakataon na para maayos yung problema tungkol sa cancellation. Kasi ang nangyari, kapag wala ng lunas right there and then, silang umabono. Tama, ma'am?
Po. Kami po.
Kayong umabono? Hmm. Tulad nito, yung sa, ang may problema yung printer, yung pagbasa ng printer. Oh, cancellation yon. Eh, sila nag-abono. Siyempre, sabihin nung mananaya, eh, hindi naman yan tinaya ko. Bakit nyo ako bigyan ng ganong ticket na mali? Of course. Cancel na yon. Kasi sabihin ng tao, hindi ko na ituloy yung laro ko. Abono sila. So, yan dapat ang i-correct ninyo. Hindi yung i-correct by way of terminating their contracts.
Ay, hindi po termination yung po. Ang ginawa namin, ni-stop po muna namin yung reimbursements, cancellation process namin. Kasi na yun hong with a large volume po, kung 500 to 600,000 a day po, very telling po yung kasi po ulit. Pero you're right, we will, in fact, yung mga legitimate concerns like oversensitivity, we forwarded it already.
I know, yung nga sinasabi kanina, masyado kayo naghihigpit until such time na ginawa niyong rason, yung paghihigpit, na hanggang sa ma-terminate sila. Di ba, Ms. Pauline, sinasabi niyo, Ms. Javier,
na sana. Mr. Chair, hindi po. We cannot coexist without the traditional dahil marami pa rin ho talang nasa traditional. In fact, iba po ang market ng traditional. Iba rin po yung nag-online.
I understand.
Kaya nga po, sir, if I may, there is always a different market for the online kahit po sa ibang bansa. The traditional, the over-the-counter po is always there. Kasi po ang nature po ng mananayatin is very superstitious po yan. Eh. Suki-suki po yan. So we understand that. But we will seriously look at the problems po ng mga legitimate cancellation. Yan po, I will promise you po, after this, we will have to sit down on that. Maybe we put a cap on saan ang pwedeng...
And then if you were to ask me, Mr. Chair, yung mga cancellation na beyond their control na may problema ay PCSO, dapat ma-refund, ma-reimburse yung mga nag-abono. Ibalik yung mga pera nila. Kasi karamihan sa mga teller ay nag-abono. Kasi hindi naman nila kasalanan eh. Bakit hindi?
So, Mr. Chairman, sino ang provider ng system sa Lotto Outlets?
Ito sa joint venture po.
Ano pong pangalan?
It's a Pinoy Lotto.
So yung
joint venture,
yung lot, yung physical lotto outlets, yung sinasabi nila na may printer, magbibigay ng thermal paper, ang provider niyan is Pinoy Lotto. So dapat ina-assess din ninyo siya, anong performance ng kanyang system, kung punit ang thermal paper, yung dust ay nag-accumulate, nasisira yung pagbasa ng mga QR code o whatever, mga 10 pesos, 300 pesos ang lumalabas, software problem yun.
Mm-hmm.
Is that your responsibility as PCSO or as a provider's responsibility?
Well, yung papers po, if that is defective, then we are to blame. Pero again, kung hindi naman po yun ang reason, we have to look into it, if it's really the paper. Kasi sabi ko nga sa inyo, hindi naman po across the board yung nakita namin eh. Very specific areas po eh.
Ang alam ko yung meaning nyo, Mr. Robles, ng nakita ninyo, siguro you looked at your computerized systems, yung online ninyo. Pero ito yung hindi niyo, ito yung mga reklamo hindi niyo makikita eh. Yung punit yung papel, mali ang pagka-print, ang nasa lahat din na nila rin report eh. Hindi niyo nakita yan sa main office ninyo, imposible na. Pero now na nalaman nila na alam na ninyo na marami pa lang nagtitiis na lang, inaabsorb na lang yung loss kasi there is no effective reportorial system, you must put one in place, require it from that provider, Pinoy Lotto. Pinoy Lotto dapat galingan ni Pinoy Lotto, tapos dapat may feature naman ng immediate cancellation, that should be a feature at the immediate one, yung pagka place ng bet, either hindi nagbayad yung tumaya o whatever, dapat merong may feature na cancellation of the bet. Software,
may reason. At binigyan na reason.
Oh, bigyan na reason. I mean, lagyan ng menu of the reasons. Yes. I mean, hindi pa software, yes, lang po. Hindi pa software.
Parang sa kayo, hindi na mag-abono yung mga teller.
Pacific Online Systems Corp, you know how to write code, di ba? I mean, can that be
done? Yung Pinoy.
Hindi, pero okay, masking them kasi online betting din sila eh. That's code. Madali lang yan sa code, right?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. Huh? Pwede po siyang additional.
Yeah, you can give a grace period of 2 minutes.
Meron siyang 5 minute na.
Oh, 5 minutes grace period.
Dati po sa traditional system.
Yeah, di ba? I mean, tinatanong lang kita, not as the ano, but parang as someone in the business, di ba? Parang kayang gawin niya, no? It should not be insurmountable, di ba?
Yes po. Also, number center.
Ganun lang siguro, Mr. Chairman, that the PCSO family, itrato niyong pamilya din ninyo itong mga outlets natin. Ngayon lang ba sila nagkaroon ng tay makasalita na narinig ninyo? Wala ba tayong regular ano? Wala bang, na hindi na, wala na intervention ng Senado? Wala bang regular ano kayo? Stakeholders forum or summit? Whatever.
Acknowledge AGM. Liz Gaboy, siya po ang head ng aming branch operations. He's been here for the longest time.
Go ahead, state your name.
Sir, I'm Remelisa Gaboy, the AGM for branch operations sector, handling all the Lotto agents po. Sir, kami po in partners po sa kanila. Lahat po ng concern nila, last December po, lahat po ng branch managers natin, nag-meeting po sa kanila para to address po lahat ng mga concerns nila. Please understand that we are transitioning into a PLS. So lahat po kami, October po nag-start yan, marami po kaming naging challenges. So ngayon po, we are, opo, October lang po. So we are very sensitive po, that is right. Pero po yung sinasabi nilang concerns nila, in-elevate na rin po namin yun sa JV Lotto. So we are addressing po
okay,
that one.
Po. Okay, thank you. Now, doon ako sa nagbumangkang kawawa yung mga teller. Ilan na po sa inyo po monitoring ang na-cancel dahil ang pagkakamali ay sa printer, ang pagkakamali ay sa system?
Reported lang po nila ngayon sa amin yun eh. Siguro po may mga na-receive na po kaming mga about mga 25 lang po na sumusulat sa amin for their concerns na ganun po.
Pero isn't it right? Tama si Senator Coco Pimentel, na evaluate niyo po yung provider niyo, yung Pinoy, anong pangalan nun?
Yes, sir. Sir, we already...
Kung kinakailang sibakin niyo yun at magpaano kayo muna, magpabid kayo ng bagong provider.
Sir, we already wrote din po regarding these concerns
and
po.
And what was their answer to the letter you sent them?
Wala pa po kaming na-receive na ano po.
Eh, kailan kayo sumulat sa kanila?
Parang 2 weeks ago po, sir.
2 weeks ago lang? Eh, matagal na itong problema to.
Ang cancellation nag-start ng...
November
po nag-start yung cancellations. November 30 po.
Okay. Ma'am, regardless kung magkano amount, basta yung na-cancel yung ticket dahil sa computer system, kasalanan po ng Pinoy, pangalan niya ulit?
Pinoy Lotto po, JV Pinoy Lotto.
Pinoy Lotto at kasalanan po ng PCSO, gusto ko po ma-refund. Basta't valid, pag may mga kopya sila ng mga ticket, pinakita sa inyo, i-refund. Wala na pong cheche-bureche, gusto ko po ma-refund. Magkano ang sweldo ng mga tailor? Below minimum, kuminsan wala pa sa minimum. Pagkatapos, dudugasan pa. I-refund. Hindi ako papayag. Oh, 400 pesos a day, tapos mag-abono sila 500. Diba? Refund po. Hindi ako papayag. Lahat ng mga tailor na nag-abono dahil sa kasalanan ng Pinoy Lotto, magpakita kayo ng ebidensya at kailangan i-refund. It doesn't matter kung yung Pinoy Lotto mag-refund o yung PCSO.
Sige po, we will take that in consideration, lalo na po kung valid talaga. Kaya nga po, sinulatan namin, we have to check kung totoo yung oversensitive, kasi maaari nga naman po talaga.
Sir,
so, sir, we will just allow us po to do the processing lang po, kasi maaabuso din po. Ganyan po yung nangyari nung nakaraan po.
I understand, of course, sir. Pero kaya sabi ko nga, magpakita lang sila ng ebidensya na yung cancellation ay pagkakamali ng Pinoy Lotto at ng PCSO na walang kinalaman sila.
Opo, we will determine that po.
Once determined, kailangan i-refund sila, yung mga teller. Kasi sila po yung tinatamaan, sila po yung nag-abono. Yun po yung point ko rito. Nagkakaintindihan po ba tayo? Okay? So, Ms. Salvador, okay sa inyo? Ito, soli ko na pong ticket nyo. Okay, resibo nyo po ito para maka-refund po kayo. Sayin din po yan, no? Ilang hundred yan.
Kasi yung iba, sir, naitapon na.
Wala na.
Naitapon na. Problema. Wala na kaming proof.
Wala na. Paano yun? Wala bang way na malaman yun, Mr. Robles? Sa computer? Oh. Sige po. Ipakita natin yung sa PCSO later para
Nagbigay po ako ng letter sa kanila nung pag-start ng cancellation.
Kailan po?
November. Monday yun eh. Monday. Nagpasa na ako ng letter.
Noong November?
November 13 siya nag-start. Hapon nagpasa ako ng letter sa kanila.
Okay, sige. November 13. Nakatanggap kayo ng reply dun sa letter nyo?
Wala po. Nagpa-follow up lang po ako. Tapos, ipinasa ako sa gaming department kay... forgot the name.
Okay. So in short, nagkaroon ba ng resulta yung pagpa-follow up niyo po?
Wala pa po hanggang.
Hanggang ngayon?
Kami, bali ano daw po, for, ang tawag doon, yung parang for discussion pa.
For discussion. O ayan po,
AGM. Nag-follow pa ako kay Mr. Randy.
November 13 hanggang ngayon, November, December, January, 2 months na, wala pa rin siyang nakukuhang kasagutan doon sa kanyang problema. At pinagpapasapasan siya parang bola. Yes, ma'am.
Your Honor, nakipag-meeting po ako sa kanila, if you remember po.
Ma'am, yung meeting po natin regarding po dun sa nawala ng machine.
Hindi po, marami po yun. Kasama po yung ano.
Kasama din po.
Meron po tayong minutes niyan, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Continuous po na nakikipag-usap po kami sa inyo. Lagi
ma'am
po yan. Ang our office is always open po sa inyo. Lagi po yan. Meron po tayong mga minutes of the meeting po niyan.
Bali, ang meeting po natin ng December 21.
Apo.
Regarding po dun sa mga nawala ng machine. Tapos sinama ko na rin yung sa cancellation at saka yung mga
Yes po, pati hours. Sa thermal rolls. Mm-hmm. Opo.
Pero no more, hindi na ulit ako nag-ano ng letter sa inyo.
Opo.
Yun lang po. Pero once in a while, nagpupunta ako sa PCSO para ma-clear ko lahat yung mga rumors na lumalabas sa mga FB page.
Yes po.
Unless kung mayroon mga katanungan pa si Senator Coco Pimentel sa susunod na hearing natin, for now I'll suspend this. Imbitahan ko po yung mga taga-Office of the Ombudsman para kunin natin opinion tungkol dito sa mga violation, glaring violations, matter of fact, na ginawa ng PCSO, kung mayroon pang makakasuhan dito sa graft and corrupt practices. So, mas maganda magsalita yung Office of the Ombudsman. Yes, Senator Coco.
Okay, kanina Mr. Chairman, na-establish natin na sabi ng PCSO may kapangyarihan sila to use a certain fund to augment the price, the jackpot. Do you also have the power to use, to access a certain fund to reimburse these tellers na naapektuhan ng ating well documented cases of loss, not due to their fault or negligence but due to the system, fault in the system? Can you do it? Biyabot na 1.7 billion yan na tulad ng inugment ninyo sa price funds.
Well, are you asking the chairman or
I'm asking them if they believe that they have the power to set aside funding to compensate our tellers.
Okay. Yes. So, sir, Senator Coco, kasi nasa banggit mo chairman, kasi kung binanggit mo si chairman, chairman, pasagutin natin. Kung hindi, are you addressing that question to AGM?
Pwede si chairman, pwede si GM. Those who are familiar with their losses. Kasi naka-cite si GM ng legal basis to augment the price fund.
Okay,
pati.
So, sige, umisa natin si chairman. Chairman, would you like to answer the question of this?
Well,
Senate Minority Leader?
I would like to suggest that since these are operational concerns, actually, not really policy issue yet. It's a matter of finding funds where we can help the lotto agents who suffered certain damages. These are concerns that should be addressed by the finance people, accounting, budget, and maybe in consultation with COA. Then when the consultation is done and it needs board action, then we will act on it.
Pero siguro naman offhand, you have the guts to augment your jackpots by 1.7 billion, you can set aside fund to compensate the real damaged tellers and lotto operators. Of course, ang understanding natin kanina is aware kayo that some are gaming the system, trying to game the system. Hindi kasama sa usapan yung mga yon. Okay? Ito yung mga kasama sa usapan natin, yung sila Miss Salvador na kitang-kita nyo naman from experience yun, real life experience yun eh. Okay? Yun ang, look for that fund. At i-announce nyo na na there is that fund so that you can help them. Kaya nyo nga yung 1.7 billion na laki lang to augment the jackpot prices. Kaya din niyo po ito. I'm sure.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, I fully agree with this statement and we will exert effort to find the funds.
Thank you. Senator Coco, Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel, as I promised earlier, para mapagbigyan natin yung maraming mga katanungan mula sa mga maraming mananaya, I would call for an executive session, Senator Coco, tungkol dun sa nanalo para gusto ko malaman yung identity noon natin sa Senado in an executive session nang sa gayon masatisfy natin yung mga mananaya. Kasi ang sinasabi, ito'y kumakalat na sa kahaka na tropa raw ni GM ang nanalo. Yun lang. Can we do it now?
Yes.
Yeah. Siguro secure natin yung lugar at maraming maalis dito muna. Okay. So, session is suspended for the meantime. Okay.